can start the live streaming. Namaste to all of you. A very warm welcome to this evening's program. Friends, after the unlock down one has started, Pragya Bharati Telangana has been doing these calls in a very structured way. We are doing it two or three per week, whereas our Karimnagar unit is still doing it on a daily basis for the Telugu audience. We thank you all for your support all this while. And today we have Sri K.K. Mohammed Ji with us. Friends, before I give the floor to him, let me kindly introduce Pragya Bharati to you, to those of you who have come for the first time. And then also it is my courtesy to do a brief introduction to Mohammed Ji, though he is very well known to all of you. Still, it is my courtesy to do a small brief introduction. Friends, Pragya Bharati is an intellectual forum which was founded about 28 years back. The first founding members were Dr. D. Hanuman Chaudhary Ji, Padma Shri awardee. He was a former chairman of BSNL, and also he was an advisor to IT, advisor and IT affairs to the Chief Minister of Andhra Pradesh. And then, of course, we all know Shri Ram Madhav Ji, who is now moved on as the General Secretary of BJP at the national level. Then B.S. Sharma Ji, who is a pharmaceutical professional, he is also on the call. And then two great stalwarts who are no more with us, Vakati Pandaranga Rao Ji and Harihara Sharma Ji. These five people started, they were the first signatories of this organization called Pragya Bharati. The aim of this organization was to promote Bharatiyata, Indianness among intellectuals, and then bring more and more intellectuals to the fold of nationalistic way of looking at things. We publish a monthly magazine by name Bharatiya Pragya. This has been published for the past 20 years. Those of you who have not subscribed to it, kindly subscribe to it. This is not available on newsstand. This is only available on subscription basis. Because of this coronavirus thing, last 2 months issues have not gone out. We promised you that all the 3 months, April, May and June would be dispatched in the next few days. So kindly do subscribe to it. And then we also give an award called Pragya Puraskar to eminent citizens who have contributed immensely for the cause of Bharat. The last recipient was Dr. Satish Reddy, who is currently a scientific advisor to the Prime Minister. He, as you all know, is one of the experts in guidance system of our missile projects under the guidance of the great Bharat Ratna Abdul Kalam Ji. So friends, and then we had given it to Francois Gauthier Ji, R.V.S. Avadhanu, and so many people we had awarded. We also invest in trying to nurture new talent in terms of at the very young age in universities and others, try and give them as much knowledge which is wholesomely missing in the university education. We have about 20 and odd branches, units in the state of Telangana. And we have been conducting these programs among intellectuals in various fields, be it history related, be it economy, be it medical, agriculture, women affairs, you name it. Anything to do with intellectual, Pragya Bharati has been in the forefront of trying to create a Bharatiya narrative. Now, friends, it's my great pleasure and privilege to introduce you, Shri K.K. Mohammed Ji. As you all are aware, he is a very well-known figure. He is an archaeologist of eminence. He retired as regional director of Archaeological Survey of India for the North India. And he's a Padma Shri awardee. Post-retirement, he also worked for the Aga Khan Trust between 2013 and 2016. While we all know that he was famously associated with the Ram Janma Bhoomi excavation, he did this under the leadership of the great Baby Lal. Baby Lal Ji was the one who was a pioneer in many of the excavations post-independence. And after the pioneering efforts of BBLRG, you know, the government of India has not probably invested so much in archaeology after that. But people like Muhammad Ji and others have done yeoman service to this nation by restoring, you know, excavating so many things which bring out the glory of Bharat. Today, we are not discussing about his excavations of Ram Janmabhoomi related things. That is all in the public domain and all of you have read it, especially the book that he wrote, I, an Indian, in Malayalam that he wrote, became quite controversial with many extremists in the Islamic side as well as the Marxists who threatened him or who said that he is a Sanghi and whatnot. They abused him in a big way. Yet he stood by his professional work and he really stood out as a true Bharatiya. He didn't bow to their pressure. We are so proud that he comes from a land which is now in question in terms of support to ISIS and others, which is happening in Mallapuram area. Yet we have this great Bharatiya who is embodiment of our culture, our tradition and our heritage. So today he's going to talk about his experience of dealing with dacoits in the Chambal Valley, where he had restored many ancient Hindu temples there of Pratihara time and you know so many kingdoms around 10th and 11th century. These were all destroyed over the centuries, but whereas painstakingly he revived many of them, and strangely enough, he was well supported by the dacoits of the Chambal Valley. So today he's going to talk about his experience in that. Of course, he had given a talk on this in on some other occasions, and which is available on YouTube. But we would be hearing him in flesh and blood, and hearing it from the horse's mouth is something different. After he has spoken, we will throw it open for question and answer session. We understand that there could be some challenges in terms of people who are not so inimical have created some, you know, posted some nonsense in the chat, so we have blocked them. So when you have to ask a question, kindly raise your hand and we shall check the identity of the person and only then we'll unblock them. As usual, our protocols, we would block all the chats so that there is no disturbance, there is no noise pollution, and we have a very enjoyable session with him. Friends, it's my privilege now to give the floor to Sri Muhammad Ji. Muhammad Ji, the floor is yours.
Yes, sir. Am I audible?
Yes, sir, you are audible, sir.
Okay. So thank you very much, Giridhar Ji, Mohanlal Ji, and there are a galaxy of people from Pragyaprabha. It is indeed a personal pleasure and privilege for me to address a gathering of this kind during the lockdown period. I am basically an archaeologist. So an archaeologist, he has got two independent areas of work. Number one, he explores and excavates various places like Harappa, Mohenjo-daro, Hastinapura, Ayodhya, places like this one. And then they bring out whatever was not known to earlier group of people. That is one aspect of archaeology, and that is the most well-known aspect of archaeology. But there is another one, which is known as conservation and preservation of the monument. Although this work has been going on since long, it has never come to occupy the imagination of the people. So I just wanted to highlight what are the problems, what are the challenges, what are the other issues we are facing it, and how to solve those problems and how we have solved this problem. And in this category, I'm taking you to a place known as Bateshwar. Bateshwar means Bada Ishwar. That is, the great Ishwar is Lord Shiva in this case. So Bateshwar is in the Chambal Valley. So what is the problem of Chambal Valley? In Chambal, of course, we have got some of the dreaded dacoits. So if these temples and other things, historical monuments are in such an area, there you will not be able to do any kind of work unless and until you get their express permission. So in this thing, there were 200 temples at one place known as Dispateshwar. You don't have any other place in India where you have 200 temples. You have Jageshwar. In Jageshwar, you have got 124. That is in Uttaranchal. There also, I had carried out the same kind of work, but they were smaller temples in Jageshwar. It is one of the most important 12 Jyotirlingas places also. And then we have got Aihole, that is in Karnataka. There we have got 108 temples. But here so far we have encountered 200 temples, remains of 200 temples. It could go further also. So now, before starting the work, we had to get their express permission. So getting permission is not that easy also. So there were few surrender dacoits while I was working in Madhya Pradesh, that is in Bhopal. I had read about him in one of the books written by Dom Moraes. The name of the book is Answered by Flutes. So there was one Lichu Singh. He was a boy of 20, 22. At that time, he became a dacoit. And then how he surrendered. So that was the story of that one. And he was occupied. I mean, he was working in Madhya Pradesh. So I got into touch with him. And then there was a police officer. He was from Trichur. Trichur also, it's known as, from Kerala. His name is Vijayaraman. Vijayaraman was he retired as the DIG. And he was actually, it was he who had shot dead Pan Singh Tomar, the legendary dacoit. Pan Singh Tomar, when this man was, that is, Vijayaraman was only at the age of 30, 31. And now there is a film also on Pan Singh Tomar. And then there were some surrendered dacoits in the area we were working. So they were all, they gave us full support, not the dacoits. And then a discussion started. So now the first question was, why should you conserve temples which is there in the forest area? So those people told them, see, these are the monuments of Archaeological Survey of India. And it's their mandate to conserve it and preserve it. But the question was, the most important question was, now this team is being headed by a Muslim. So why should a Muslim take up the conservation of the temples? So, people told them, no, he has got a track record and it is his duty also. And he has been doing it in other places. And now the problem is, his name is Muhammad. So when we call Muhammad, we remember, when we say Muhammad, we remember Muhammad Ghazni, Muhammad Ghori, who had completely demolished our temple. So all these problems were there. And then finally, they gave us permission. And we went to the area. So I'll be starting from there. Now, how did we go and what we saw there? We'll share the screen.
One second, sir. I'll give you that. Yeah, please. You can now share it.
This is, of course, it needs no introduction. this is the group of Bhateshwar temples. And a temple of 8 from 9th, 10th century in North India, they would be having, this is, they would be having this. This is known as Vedibandha, this portion. This is Kura, Kumbha, Kalasha. Then you have the Janga portion. It is like a human body. Then you have the Varandiga portion, Shikara, and then Amalka. So this is a typical North Indian temple of 9th century. Now, when we say Chambal Valley, and especially for the people of Telangana, Kerala, Tamil Nadu, it's not a forest area. Chambal is not a forest area. Chambal forest, we call it. Chambal is not a forest area. But it has gone a maze of huge dunes and dunes and dunes. It's for miles and miles together. And this has got pathways also inside this one, which is known either to the stakeholders or to the people who are living there. And this is again the same thing. Some of the most prominent decoy, just see this one. He is Mansi. You might have perhaps read about him in so many fold this one stories. Just look at his record. He looks like Socrates, the great philosopher. But this man, he had committed 1,112 robberies, 185 murders, including killing of 32 police officers. But he was dead long back in 40s. This is Mohar Singh. Mohar Singh just passed away 4 or 5 months back. And before that, he wrote a letter to the Honorable Prime Minister about these temples, because the conservation work has been stopped since the last 9 years. It's not going on. So he was pained that it had been stopped. So he wrote a letter. But just before 1.5 months, he passed away also. So he surrendered to the police in 1972. And he sent us a copy of the letter which he had sent to the Honorable Prime Minister. This is Malkhan Singh. Malkhan Singh, he had 100 cases against him. Madhav Singh. Madhav Singh was with Mohar Singh. This is the famous, this one, Pan Singh Tomar, whom Vijay Raman had shot dead. Here is Vijay Raman. He is from Thrissur. And when he just passed out, it was when Pan Singh Tomar was shot dead. This is, 4 years back, I went for a lecture of this kind to Pune. So I met both of them. Mr. and Mrs. Vijay Raman, she was working in tourism department. So we had very close connection. That is how I came to know about Vijay Ramanji. And then I came to know that he's from Trichur also. And it's not only during the night time, even during the daytime also, we would be moving around there. These people would be moving around. If you go to Morena Chambal, even now also, because people will move around on a bicycle by having this one, banduk with them. Sometimes there will be, these kinds of fights also among them. So after getting the permission, with all tension, excitement, and trepidation, a small team went to the area. And when we went to the area, and we saw the whole site like this. Just look at this photograph. No two stones are together. Perhaps in a very powerful earthquake, the entire temple town had come tumbling down like a pack of cards, without sparing anyone to narrate even the harrowing details of a terror-stricken story. It was not an attack like Mohammad Ghazni, Mohammed. It was not an attack, because in an attack, what they used to do is they will demolish it, but at the same time, they would be chopping off the nose, various parts. Here, nothing of that had taken place. And just see how things are lying. So, when these photographs were seen by a travel writer known as Kevin Strange, he saw the entire, file photographs when he came to the site, went to the site. He said that this is the largest jigsaw puzzle in the world he has ever seen. He had been almost all to all the monuments, and a prolific writer also, Kevin Strange, English writer. So he said that this is the largest jigsaw puzzle I have seen in the world. So you are not going there to see the romance of music of the ruins, because we have our own another duty, and that duty is very important, because we had to sift through all these things and then ask them each one. We had to put a tongue in each and every stone and make them speak. We will ask them, where were you in the original, when the temple was standing? And then we had to press him to speak. And then you had to piece together all these things accordingly as per the agamas of 8, 9, 10 centuries. Because we had several books, ancient books, speaking about our temple architecture. And temple architecture means the earliest one was Manasara. Then 9th and 10th century it was Mayamada. Then there was Samarangana Sutradhara in 10th, 11th century. In South India we have got Tantra Samuchaya. Many, many things are there. So you have to piece them together accordingly. So this is the greatest work we are just going to do. And I will be doing it just in front of your eyes. So this is one frame. Let us see some more frame. Let's see temples. And very fortunately for me, few temples were just standing like this. Like a sentinel of its former glory. Another, this one frame, third frame, fourth frame. Just see how things are lying down. We have to jump, from one place to another place. You can just see how things are lying. And also here. Here we'll be making six temples by using these fragments. And those, I mean, here there will be one here, it will be like that. This temple, any moment it may fall down. The external portion has already fallen down and the internal portion is very precariously standing. इसके बारे में अक्सर मैं कहता हूँ, इतना टूटा हूँ मैं, छूने से बिखर जाएंगे. I am so fragile that by the mere touch of your hand I may fall down. This is another temple 20 kilometers away. It is known as Sihania. There also, it can any moment, because you know, 3-4 months back I again went to the site. It was looking so fragile. And you may ask me why the government of India is taking, and I will ask this question to you also. I am a critic. It might have fallen like this. Just an animation. One minute. Oh, here, yeah.
Huh?
Here, yeah. Animation. So I saw it like this one. Now my task starts. Whenever we take up the work, we take up it from the entrance gate. Most of these temples, they were Shiva temples. So Shiva would be having Jata Makuta. He would be having Charma Vastra also. Jadi, Charmi, Shikandi cha Sarvanga, Sarva Bhavana. Harischa Harina cha Sarva Bhuda Haraprabhu. Sarva Bhuta Haraprabhu means it is ultimately he who destroys everything. And then if anything remains, Shashudam Shiva Machudam, that's only Shiva. And there were very few Vishnu temples also. It's not, number of Vishnu temples also, but prominently Shiva temples. Now, what I'm going to do is we saw the entire thing. We were under surveillance, of course, because, you know, there was an uneasy calm. And there was an eerie silence because they will be observing, where are you going, what are you doing, and all those things. And it will be very difficult sometimes to work under that condition also. And then finally, we sat here and then discussed it. At that time, I looked at this one stone. It doesn't speak anything to an ordinary man, but for an archaeologist, that is one of the biggest clues. And in Ayodhya also, we had this kind of, you know, pillar bases. This is a pillar base. So if it is a pillar base, where is the pillar? You have the pillar here. Where is the stone on the top of this one pillar? That is lying here. And where is the crowning one? That is lying here. Here, nobody had the courage to lift anything, to steal anything, because of the presence of the dacoits. Everything was preserved here. So what I had to do it, I had to place this one over this one, this one over this one, this one over this one. But you just cannot have a Gopura Dwar, you cannot have an entrance gate by having only one pillar and one stone. So for the next one, we looked all around, we could not get it. So normally what we do is that if you don't get any answer for things, we look at God and then ask him, Ishwar bataiye. But an archaeologist is not like that. He looked down. Wo dharti maa se poochte hai. Maa, aapne kahan chipa ke rakha hai? So we looked at this one and I made a small excavation. Just see, we got the other pillar base also here. So my agreement with those people were that, I mean, if those dacoits are here, you know, then we'll be under great stress and we would not be able to work. So we just requested them that they should move away from here, and they obliged us for 4 months. So within that, I mean, we had to complete this portion also and this portion also. And then, now, where is the pillar base you got? But where is the pillar? We further excavated. Just see, we got this one also. And this area is paved. This area is paved. And similarly, this paved. And now we are going to join them together like a knee surgeon. Like an orthopedic knee surgeon, we are going to join them together. You have to bore a hole here. You have to bore a hole here. And so that, you know, it can stand on this one, on steel rod, and powerful steel rods and erudite. Just see, one is standing up. Here there is a joint, and here also there is a joint. And now where is the second pillar? Just see, it's also standing before you. Now, this area has to be paved. This area has to be paved. All this one, 1, 2, 3, 4 temples, their foundation is sagging. So what we have to do is, we have to bring them down. All this thing, we have to bring them down, give a very strong foundation, and then re-erect it as it was. For those one, you have to dismantle and you have to reconstruct. 1, 2, 3, 4, all these 4 temples. So before that, you had to photographically document it, and then also you have to make a drawing of all these things, because, you know, you should know, while with this one rebuilding, you should know which stone has to go to which place. So we are very particular about it. So it was photographed, it was drawings were made, and then the entire thing was brought down, niche rakha pure ki pura. And then it was re-erected as it was. Just going to see the transformation which is going to take place right before your eyes. Just see.
Wow.
Om Shambho Shiva. I mean, nothing else you can speak of.
Yeah, absolutely brilliant. Yeah.
And the pillar which was broken, the pillar which was fallen, and the pillar which was in fragments, that is now standing before you, hale and hearty. And all the temples, they are now pulsating with life. All of them are pulsating with life. So when my dacoit friends, you know, saw these things have taken place, I mean, within 4 months, you know, that was a kind of great, I mean, that brought great admiration from those people. Unka kehna ye takharta ye bilkul aashchadi ki baat ye kamal ka kaam hai karke. So that was a kind of certificate for us also, because, you know, up till now we were working under great tension, because, you know, you are under trepidation, tension, and although the excitement of the work is there, you know, still you are under tension. But once you get the certificate, and now you can freely move around. So that was one thing. Chaliye. And now you had seen it like this one. We have made it like this one. And we have a long way to go. Let us just say namaskar to Lord Shiva and then move ahead. I saw this temple. The front portion has fallen away. This is also, there are number of cracks in this one also. Number of cracks in this one also. And the avalka is upside down. Now, is it a Shiva temple or Vishnu temple? That was the biggest question. Inside there was nothing. And if the inside portion, that is the Garbhagriha, doesn't speak anything, then we look at this place. Lalata Bhima, we call it. So if it is Vishnu, of course Garuda would be there. So, but here it was, you know, Ganapati. Ganapati, of course, is the son of Lord Shiva, but at the same time, sometimes he comes in a very deceptive way, because he is also treated as the Vigna Vinayaka, the one who removes all kinds of obstacles. So in that case, he could be there in the Vishnu temple also. Then for an archaeologist, I looked at this one, this cap. This is rectangular. For me, that is enough, because that will give me the clue whether it is a Shiva temple or Vishnu. Had it been a square one, then I would have called it, this is Dhujastambha, Vishnu Dhujastambha. But here it is elongated, which means this is Nandi Sthan. A Sthan for Nandi, Vrishabh. So I just recited the mantra, Vahanam Vrishabho Yasya Vasuki Kandabhushanam Vame Shakti Dharam Deva Fakaraya Namo Nama. Recited the mantra, took a pradakshina. Here there was a sloppy side was there. When I reached there, there was a very small, beautiful, cute Nandi looking at me as if he was waiting for me for the last 1,000 years. So, mujhe us time mein ek sher aaya, Urdu sher yaad aa gaya. Ye rafte muhabbat bhi, kya rafte muhabbat hai? ये रफ्त मोहब्बत भी क्या रफ्त मोहब्बत है, दिल उनका वहां धड़का, आवाज यहां आई. सो इट वॉज ए काइंड ऑफ स्पिरिचुअल कनेक्शन विथ लॉर्ड शिवा. आई मीन व्हेन ही आई मीन हर ड्रॉप देयर द साउंड केम टू मी. सो इट वॉज ऑलमोस्ट दैट काइंड ऑफ स्पिरिचुअल कम्युनियन, स्पिरिचुअल यूनियन. एंड देन वी सेरेमोनियली वी लिफ्टेड द इट, जस्ट केप्ट इट इन दिस वन, in this small gap. It was perfectly sitting, very perfectly sitting. So now what we are going to do is we are going to conserve it. See, it has been now conserved. Now you might be asking, where is Nandi? Just look at him. Small, beautiful, cute Nandi. His eyes are riveted in Lord Shiva and Parvati, and his ears are very sharp, as if he is attending to something. What is he doing? He is listening to that Om which is coming from Kailash. What is Om? Om Tad Brahma, Om Tad Vayu, Om Tad Atma, Om Tad Satyam, Om Tad Sarva. So that Om is coming from Kailash. He is from through his Gomukh. He is inhaling all those things, that mantra. And then it's coming out, exiting through his ears. So that is why even if we go to many of these ancient places, Banaras mein Kashi Vishwanath mein chale jaiye, ya apna isme, I mean our Ramappa temple in this one, Andhra Pradesh, or Kailasha temple, or any of our temple, Brihadishwara, Kanjipuram temples, Ujjain ka mandir jaiyega. Ladies, before going to Shiva, what they used to do is they will take a pradakshina of Nandi so that they can inhale that one, that Om which is coming from Kailasha, and then they would purify themselves, then only they would go to Shiva, Shivalinga, whatever it is there. So that is even now some of the ancient, some of the big families, I mean traditional families, they are even now maintaining the system. I've seen it in Banaras mein. So again, you had seen it like this one, and we have made it like this. And now I saw these three temples like this one, started the work. All the fragments are lying there because, you know, nobody had the courage to come to this place. If at all they come, you know, they would be kidnapped, and then they had to give 1 crore sometime, depending upon their this one. So I had to bring them down again, all the three temples. This is in a very awkward position. Any moment it may fall down. Half of the shigara has fallen down. And I brought them down. Then strong foundation was given so that, you know, for the next 5,000 years, nothing should happen to it. The work is going on. It's going on. Now we will be completing the shigara of this one, and then we will take up this one. Yes, see. A thing of beauty and absolute finish. Absolute finish. Just look at them, how you had seen it earlier and how you are, I mean, how we have made it. This looks like the setting of an English horror story. Dracula ka setting jaise hai, waise lagenge aapko ye dekhne ke liye. The Garbhagraha is there, and this is the Andarala portion, but this Andarala is very precariously standing again, only one stone. And here, Budhono gir gaya hai. And look at this one, this is also sagging. So humne again, we brought them down. Just look at it again. A gem of a rare workmanship. A gem of a rare workmanship. Look at this cadence, grace of these carvings. It's not only the architectural marvel, but the cadence, grace of this carving. That is also very alluring. And this is a classical case which you could have seen only in Cambodia. In Cambodia, even now, the Great Archaeological Survey of India is working for the Cambodian government. There are many temples like this one. Mostly our friends from Tamil Nadu and Andhra Pradesh had gone to those areas, and they had built huge temples. We cannot imagine that kind of huge temples. Where you will be seeing things like this one. And look at this tree. This has completely eaten away the whole temple, the shikara portion of the temple. And the roots of this temple that has gone through the ribs of the temple and cleaved him asunder into various sections. Now, in order to save the temple, you can cut down the tree. And otherwise, you cannot cut down the tree. But before cutting down the tree, you had to seek the I mean, this one permission, not only permission, you have to apologize to the tree. Namaste, Vriksho Chamundu. You have to seek his pardon. I am doing it as there is no other way of rescuing this temple. And your duty is not only to seek pardon of this tree, but also of the tree, of the birds that would be roosting over this one. And you have to tell them, Anyartha Vasam Parikalpayandu. You migrate from this tree to some other habitable tree. Wo kide makudo se bhi aapko permission lena padega. So we sought the refuge, sought them in this one pardon from all these things. And when we cut down the tree, it fell down like autumn leaves. And then we had to re-erect them from the very beginning. Humne kaam shuru kar diya. यहां तक पहुंच गया. अब जो ना आपको 5-6 रद्दे और लगाना है, यहां तक आ गया, यहां तक आ गया, यहां तक आ गया. नाउ वी हैव टू हैव द लास्ट कैपिंग स्टोन्स. जस्ट सी द मोस्ट ब्यूटिफुल टेम्पल, फ्रेश. Although it is 1,000 years old, fresh, clean, unspoiled, unspotted by time and tide, it looks like a jewel casket, bedecked and bejeweled. Very beautiful jewel casket, jaisa lagta hai. Bahut hi khoobsurat lagta hai ye mandir. Jab bhi main jata hoon, main jaake pranam karta hoon hamesha. And there were many instances like this one. Aapne aisi dekha tha, and we have made it like this. एंड दिस इज अनदर टिपिकल केस. इस तरह के कई हमें मिल गया. एंड नाउ प्लीज गिव मी अ मिनट, आई विल जस्ट चेंज इनटू सेकंड वन बिकॉज I have to go to the second one, the same thing.
So this is a challenge for all the next generation. They'll need to take the help of younger generation.
Second minute. So, an archaeologist, I was just walking over this one. An archaeologist is, because you know, even without GPR survey, am I audible?
Yes, sir, you are.
Even without GPR survey, he would be able to predict certain things with his sixth sense. So, because you know, his mind is always devoted to Mother Earth. So, his mind meanders through the fascinating labyrinth, and then it comes out what is hidden below this one. I was just walking over this one. I could feel that I am going to get six temples from down below, my shoes. So I cut down the tree. Ye ped bhi kaata humne. When we excavated this portion.
So you are not shared it, sir. You have to share it.
Not shared? Achha.
No, you're not shared. Mm-hmm. Ganesh, the share screen in the bottom.
Share screen is not coming. Shaheen? Isko share screen karna hai.
You can click on the share screen button at the bottom. Yeah.
Okay.
Achha. Yeah. Now, it's
So, whatever I had spoken last time, could you hear it or no?
We could hear, but there was no presentation. I mean, the slide was not shared then.
Right? Uh-huh. Okay. So when I walked this one, I could, because I'm an archaeologist, he developed some kind of connection with Mother Earth, and he would be able to tell you even without GPS survey what is hidden. I mean, tentatively, not very accurately, what is hidden below. So we just, I just walked over here. And I could predict that I'm going to get 3-4, or it could be sometimes 2 also, or 1 also, temples from beneath this earth. So, just see 1, 2, 3, 4 temples we could. Just by the color of the this one, the temple itself, you can see that they are fresh, mean fresh temples coming out of its own tomb. अपने मकबरे के से जन ये बाहर निकला है एंड नाउ इट वाज दिस इज दिस टेंपल एंड फ्रॉम हियर वी हैव बीन एबल टू गेट 1, 2, 3, 4 टेंपल्स इट वाज जस्ट कमिंग आउट लाइक दिस वन एंड देन यू हैव टू कैरी आउट सम कंजर्वेशन वर्क अब ये है इस तरह है Again, before and after. And then in the initial stage, we were not having water. Even the dacoits were also not getting water, but they had many people to bring them water. Now we had to take up the work at a larger scale. So this area was not like this. It was completely filled. And then we explored the area and we could come to the conclusion that here we are going to get water. So when we excavated it, we got not only copious amount of water, but from here we could get 3 temples also. So from here we could get water also. From here we could get 3 temples also. For that we have again to cut down this tree. यहां जब एक्सकेवेट किया तो यहां से 3 मंदिर मिल गए हम लोगों को इनिशियली लाइक दिस 1, 2, 3 अब फिर यहां जब खोदा तो हम लोगों को कॉपियस अमाउंट ऑफ वाटर बहुत पूरा भरा हुआ जस्ट सी इतना जब पानी मिला तो खैर तो उन लोगों ने कहा ये मन चंगा है तो कटौती में गंगा If mind is pure, you know, Ganga itself will come to your doorstep. So you saw it like this one. We have made it like this one now. 1, 2, 3, 3. Again, temples. This I saw it like this. एंड देखिए हमने इसको एक मंडपिका टेम्पल बनाया इससे इसी चीजों से is a Mandabiga temple. Now only this stone and this stone we had to use new stones. Otherwise, everything is by using the same kind of things. And this is, this was a big temple, and all the fragments are just lying like this one. And see how we are going to build up it. The Amalga is there. It has come up to this level now. It has come up to this level. And just see. Look at it. All the three temples. And all the three temples are standing like graceful dancers. And with a striking posture also. And look at this. Again, this carving, beautiful carvings. And now, what I'm going to show you is the main part of my presentation. I walked over this area and then said, we are going to have six temples. And then from just behind it, eight temples. And then from the front portion, we'll be getting six temples. So totally 20 temples would be now rising from its own ashes. Chidabasme, iskisi mandiro ka chidabasme, they would be now coming up, rising up. Dil tham ke baithega aur dekhega kaise hai. So for me, the clue was only this one. The steps. Again, the steps. So first of all, you have to cut down the tree. Namaste, Vrikshu, Chamandu. We removed the trees. It became like this. So this is from here, we'll be having six temples. You have the steps here, just from behind. It will be eight temples, and from here, it will be six temples. Totally 20 temples. And each part, now we have to see which part fits into which one, and it should be as per Agamas, it should be as per Mayamata. We started building up. It's almost one is being completed. Two. Now scaffoldings also we have removed. Compare it. Please compare it with this one. But you might be asking that where are the six temples which I had promised? And again, please hold your breath and just count. Just see. Three. Four. Five and a half. Just see six temples right before you rise. And you see mandiron ka chidabasm se. Jaise Manikarnika ghat me, jo Banaras ke jo Manikarnika ghat me jahan Harishchandra ji uske manager the, wahi agar jo murde jo agar khade ho jayenge, wo jaise lagenge usi tarike se hamara mandiron ka jana bilkul ekdam. बिल्कुल एकदम ट्रैफिक जाम ऑफ टेम्पल्स जो ना यहाँ हो गया सिक्स टेम्पल्स एंड लुक एट द दिस वन द सिमेट्री द एलिवेशन द बैलेंस द ग्रेसनेस ऑफ दिस टेम्पल ईच स्टोन दैट हैज गॉन इनटू द क्रिएशन ऑफ इट इज वेरी वेल कंसीव्ड cut and polished like a sparkling diamond, and each such prepared stone is then crafted like a jeweler into the second into third one, third into fourth into fifth one, and then the whole thing has been brought into a very brilliant culmination to make it an enchanting musical note. Musical note of Ilayaraja? No. Tyagaraja? No. Tansan? No. Then who? I say the real Brahma himself, who is not only the Vastu Brahma, he is also the Nada Brahma. So it has come into that, this one. In Chinese and Greek mythology, we all know that there is a bird known as Phoenix, which comes out of its own ashes. Similarly, right before your eyes, these temples have started coming down, standing up from their own tombs. And now, 6 temples are there. Now I'll go to the backside, 8 temples. Just look at its backside also. My people are working. Now, see 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Now this portion also we have to conserve, completely conserved. This was one of the surrendered dacoits. It was mainly he who was speaking with the dacoits. And this is another man. His name is Gujjar, Ishwan Gujjar. And this was another man. These were the main people who were talking to dacoits. So this is also now completely conserved. And look at this thing. You see, Tariqat, there are 3 terraces like this one. If you stand here, I mean, you will feel the vibration. You will feel that in the horizon, Lord Shiva is looking at you and he is seeing, overseeing everything. And he is over, I mean, you can see him in his Nataraja form there in the horizon. And casting his cosmic, this one, halo all around the world. It has become such a great place. And I say often that if the great Lord Shiva himself comes down into the earth, he would prefer to leave for some days here in Bhateshwar. It has become so beautiful. And now I think perhaps he might be thinking of marrying also, because you know, till that time, I mean, after the death of his earlier wife, I mean, refused to marry. And these places, if you are going to excavate, you'll be getting another this one, terrace of temples like this one. This was the former earlier temple, and this was the 6th temple. This is the 8 temples that we excavated so far. Till today it has not been excavated. You will be getting many temples from here. So aapne aise dekha tha, and now it is like this. These 3 temples. Here also there are 6 temples, 4, 5, 6. So it is all in terrace, 1, 2, 3 terraces. You can see this is the 6th temple, 8 temples, and this is the 6th temple. And now there will be one more. I think most probably there might have been 7 terraces like this one, just to show that the concept of Surya. And now if you excavate this portion also, you'll be getting many temples, but even till today it is just lying there. This area, I saw it like this, and by using these fragments we have rebuilt 8 temples here. Just see. It is still lying there, It has not been done. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 temples are there. By using the same fragment, just compare it, this portion with this one. And now you have only this temple standing, and by using the fragments lying there, we have been able to rebuild on the same kind of, on the foundation is even now there. So you have to rebuild on the same foundation. You have to remove them, give a strong foundation, and then redo it. All this, you know, they have come out of their own tomb. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Only this was the earliest temples. So now the whole place has become like this. Now I'll go to the 1 minute, the third part. Can you hear me?
We can hear you, sir. We're just waiting for you to share.
Okay.
There is a share screen button.
Which is
green one. At the bottom it will be there. Share screen button. Green arrow will be there.
I'll just get the help of my daughter.
Share screen.
Yes.
Show him the button,
he'll
be able to do it. Can you see? Yes, sir, we can see.
Okay.
Yes.
Okay. So I saw this. This one like this. So I said that what we are going to do, get is a boundary wall. And this depression means you are going to get the steps for going up. So when I excavated, I could get the boundary wall and the steps also. The steps. And one day I was moving from one temple to another temple. So now things were coming up very well. There was an extraordinary demand that they would like to meet me and talk to me. And the reason was, you know, there was, I mean, he wanted to, the biggest dacoit of the area, that his name is Nirbhay Singh Gujjar. It was he who was helping us. He wanted to surrender to the government, but he was not ready to surrender to the government of Madhya Pradesh. he wanted to surrender to UP government because he had developed some kind of discussion with them. And but he was making very extraordinary this one also demands also that he should be provided a chopper, then only a man. So like a Roman conqueror, he will go, he will surrender he, this one, which was not acceptable to the government of Uttar Pradesh also. And then he gave certain statements also in this one, Aitak channel, that he is my brother, that the chief minister of so-and-so state is my brother. Whatever he says, that I will do. So that was too much for the Uttar Pradesh government also. So both three, all the three government, because what they used to do is they will commit this one, the Koyti here, and then cross over Chambal to the other area, or commit the Koyti in UP and then cross over to this one or to Rajasthan. So all the three government, they made this one. And then finally, task force. So for the elimination of the people, his brother was shot dead. And he knew that his end is coming. So he was running away from place to place. So one day while I was moving from one place to place, and I was just trying to avoid him because, you don't have that kind of courage. So I saw a man sitting and smoking. So, I lost my patience because, although it was not inside the temple, he was smoking. I asked him, "Aapko sharam nahi aate? Aap mandir mein beedi pee rahe." So he looked at me very contemptuously, but did not say anything. But tab tak jo na mere peeche se mere jo that intermediaries, I was always keeping them with me. Wo log bahar daud ke aa gaya peeche se, mera haath pakad ke mujhse kaha, "Sir, aapse kuch mat kahiye." So when they were so much respectful for them, my own employees, then I thought that something has gone wrong. And you just cannot escape from here because in all the areas, it was surrounded by people. Otherwise also you just cannot escape. So I just sat at his feet here. And my people were also there. So then I engaged him in a discussion. I told him that, "Sir, of all these gods and goddesses, Brahma, Vishnu, Mahesh, all of them are safe here only because of you. Otherwise, they would have been either in America or in England or in some other countries. And even after this one also, the government and the police, they cannot save the whole area. It's only you who can do anything." फिर मैंने उनसे कहा कि देखिए, ईश्वर ने कुछ सोच समझ के आपको यहाँ भेजा गया है. कुछ सोच समझ के आपको ईश्वर ने यहाँ भेजा गया है. So he became very curious, what is that? Why the God has thought of, he has been sent with a great, duty. So I said, all this one temples, it was built during a dynasty known as Gujjar Pratihara dynasty. Just after Harsha in 7th century, it was they who were ruling and they had constructed this kind of temple, not only here in Madhya Pradesh and various parts of Madhya Pradesh, in Ujjain also. And also in Rajasthan, there are a number of temples like this one. And then in Uttaranchal also, in North India also, we have got very number of temples there. And all of them have been built by this illustrious dynasty known as Gujjar Pratihara dynasty. And very fortunately, your name is Nirbhay Singh Gujjar. And you belong to that illustrious great family. And that is why exactly God had chosen you for this duty of conserving and preserving this temple. Actually, that was something which he had never expected. And he was completely blown off his feet. Completely blown off his feet. He never thought it would be like this one. He was like Valmiki. He was a completely changed man. And I knew because they worship mostly because there was a Hanuman Murti there. So before going for dacoity, they worship at that place, and after coming also they worship at that place before distributing the booty. And they also have great faith in Bhagavati. Kali, Bhagavati, aap jo bhi kahiyega, Devi kahiyega. So I just recited some mantras from Devi Mahatmya. My Shasura Nirna, Shavidatri, Varade Nama. Rupam Devi, Jayam Devi, Yesho Dehi, Disho Dehi. So he was now a completely changed man. So I said that if you are here, the village people will come, because you know it was predominantly a Gujar village, because they take refuge also in such places. Because they were feeding them, they were sleeping in their own houses or in these temples. So I said, if you are here, I mean, the village people will come, but I need now expert karigar, expert craftsmen. They will not come if you are here. So Musa Pucha Kya Chahiye, I said that if you can change your this one campsite from here to some other site, then people will come. So they started obliging us and they shifted their base also, and we took up the work. And now this temple is being conserved. By using the same stone, see how we are going to rebuild it. Pura bana diya iske piche. The front portion, ye pura ban gaya. अब गर्भगृह इधर उधर पड़ा हुआ है, आई ज्वाइन देम टुगेदर, तैयार हो गया. एंड नाउ अंदर वाला पोर्शन यू हैव टू हैव ए न्यू दिस वन पिलर हियर आल्सो ए न्यू पिलर एंड देन द गिव द रूफ ओवर द दैट. काम शुरू हो गया एंड इट हैज कम इन प्लेस. अब तो आपको रूफिंग देना है, रूफिंग ह्यूज स्लैब्स चाहिए. काम शुरू हो गया, आप देखिएगा पूरा कंप्लीट हो गया. एंड नाउ हियर यू हैव टू बिल्ड अप ये बहुत बड़ा मंदिर तैयार हो गया आपके सामने. एंड नाउ ऑल दीज थिंग्स यू नो वी हैव, although they were in fragments, we have joined them together. Kabhi six pieces honge, lekin jo na ek bar hum join karke fir then we fill up this gaps also, fill up this gap and then we give you a matching this one, you would feel that it is one stone. Ab ye three pieces humko na join kar diya. So earlier after the death of Sati, Shiva did not marry, but Parvati was, I mean, doing tapasya for the marriage, and God was asking, Shiva was asking, how can I take my new wife to a place where things are not in order? But now we have placed them in order, and his Shivalaya is in very good order, and now he is ready to marry also. Just look at this Kalyana Sundara Murti of Lord Shiva. All the gods and goddesses have come for the marriage. So we got many sculptures like this one. So if marriage take place, you have to have children also. Ekatandam chaturbahu gajavaktram mahodaram siddhi buddhi samayuktam mushikarutam evaja. And if there is a god who has got both siddhi and buddhi, that is only Ganapati ji. And Ganapati was not satisfied by seeing himself. He wanted to show it to his wife also, Shakti Ganapati. Just see Shakti Ganapati. Similarly, we got a number of pieces. All of them are in Gwalior Museum now. This is Yashodhara Sindhya. And Yashodhara Sindhya is a very good, very effective, very intelligent minister. So I was constantly in touch with him. She, madam, used to call me every time, not only for this work, for various other works also. So one day made a complaint, Mohammed ji, aapne itna bada kaam kiya hai, lekin mujhe abhi tak le jaake dikhaya nahi. So I invited madam. This was the MP from that place, Mr. Argal. And it was that vote for cash wala, you know, he was the main man for that one. This is Ashwini Lohani ji, a very good officer, a very efficient officer. He was Air India chairman also. So we had a very good group there. He was in the tourism director, managing director of tourism. I was in Archaeological Survey of India, because tourism, they have got a lot of funds, but flush with funds, they don't know how to spend it. And Archaeological Survey of India, they'll be always objecting, I mean, creating objections. No, it cannot be done, this one, this cannot be done, that one. So I told him, sir, I mean, whatever work you wanted to do, you just consult me earlier so that I will tell you what has to be done, what has not to be done. So similarly, within 3-4 years, the whole Madhya Pradesh, we have completely changed like this one. You go to any of these places, Madhya Pradesh, I mean, all the monuments, central government monuments are in great, very good order, because of this joint work by ASI and state tourism and this one. And madam was a great supporter of me. And even when I had some problems also, madam supported me. And similarly, Jyothirathya Siddhaji also. And he used to say in the open meeting that if I give 100 rupees to Muhammad, then he would make it, I mean, 1,000 rupees, and then he will utilize it in the monument and he will show you. So demonstrable work karte hai tak karke bola tha. So within 4 years, the whole, his whole constituency, that is Chanderi was the constituency, has completely changed it now. So he is also very efficient minister. You don't get this kind of efficient ministers. Suppose there is a problem, you just speak to him. I could speak to him directly. So many of the secretaries were also, I mean, you speak to the minister directly and it is against the protocol. So I used to tell them, the minister talked to me directly, so I had to talk to him. So it is a very good, very powerful, very efficient ministers. Is there an efficient ministers? Both come, they don't know. They were, all, of course, at that time on two sides of the political divide, but now they have come together. This is how you had seen the whole thing. And ab ye dekhiyega ki humne kya bana diya is cheez se. Just look at it. Just look at it. It's completely transformed. And now what I have done is I have given a very beautiful garden also all around it. Beautiful garden now. Almost 1 kilometer area. I mean, I'm going to beautify. My further idea was, I mean, to have all these places. I mean, you have to afforestation karna hai. And then, and that too in Tirange color mein of this one. The phool walon ki usi tarike se karke design karke jo na, you have to have a flower garden here. Or in all this place, flowering trees come, so that you know it could be converted into a kind of a valley of flowers. I mean, there is a shortage of water, but there you can have cactus gardens also. That was what I was just thinking, cactus garden and the flowery garden. Take all this area and you have enormous one with forest department, with tourism department, reutilize it. You have to have a man who has got kind of innovative spirit. So you had seen it like this one, and it is out of that we have made it like this one. वो है ना आज तक याद है वो उजड़े दयार का मंजर मुझको आज तक याद है वो उजड़े दयार का मंजर मुझको वो निगाहों में लिए फिरता हूँ. तो उसी तरीके से जो ना वो पूरी वो कहानी जो ना हम अब भी निगाहों में लिए फिरता हूँ. So you had seen it like this one, and out of that we made it like this one, and now this is like this one. And this was our one-time supporter, Narve Singh Gujjar. And he knew that his end is coming, running from pillar to post the last days. And one day that happened in UP, he was shot dead. Police was following him very hotly on his heels. End of terror, Chambal Brigade, Narve Singh Gujjar, after he was killed in an encounter with the special task force at Etawah. And with his death, it became a problem for us. As long as he was there, we were safe. But now what has happened is, once it was known to the world that he is no more there, then the mining mafia, they came. They started rampant mining. And my temple started developing cracks. I wrote to so many people. I mean, there was no support. You know, obviously, why there was no support in such great mining works. I knew one minister was involved in that one. I went and told him, requested him, sir. तो उन्होंने कहा कि मोहम्मद जी आपका वो letter ने मुझे नहीं मिला. Then I wrote him one more letter and then went to him. तो उनसे कहा कि मोहम्मद जी आपका वो letter मुझे नहीं मिला. फिर and that minister is in a different case, व्यापम case में वो अंदर भी थे, जेल के अंदर भी थे. Then I did something which a government servant should not have done as per the rule book. But if you want to save your temples, you know, this is the only way. So what I did is I wrote a letter to, this is Papu Gujjar death. Papu Gujjar was the brother of this man. Only he was alive. All others were shot dead. So the rampant mining started. There was no stopping for it. So I did something which a government servant should not do. But except that, there was no other way also. I wrote a letter to Sudarshan ji, who was the RSS chief at that time. It was in 2007. By that time, I had completed 60 temples, not 80, 60 temples by that time. I wrote to him that what Muhammad Ghazni and Muhammad Ghori had done in those days, the same thing is being now repeated under BJP government in Madhya Pradesh. Because the BJP government, Shivraj Singh Chauhan ji ka ministry tha. And I requested him to come or get it stopped. And the greatness is that, took action within 24 hours. Perhaps Chief Minister might have been pulled up. And immediately the next day itself, police was rushed to the area along with the district magistrate, collector pahunch gaya, SP pahunch gaya. And those people also were fully armed. The mining mafia was fully armed. And there was a fiery exchange of fire between both of them. They shot at the collector also, they shot at the SP also. But anyhow, the police was able to suppress the entire thing, bring them under control. And this was that letter which I had written. That was in 15-10-7 mein tha, wo letter. And it was, of course, I knew action would be taken against me. But, you know, there was, because by this time I had completed 60 or 40. Ambika Soni was our minister in Delhi. Madam wrote a letter to Shivraj Singh Chauhan ji that law and order is under your jurisdiction. Kindly extend all kinds of help and cooperation to the Archaeological Survey of India. And by this time, the Honorable Chief Minister, he had taken action. But of course, I had rubbed him on a very wrong side. So then he gave her this one reply, but the last portion was, for taking action against me for writing a letter. I'm leaving the issue of the propriety of some correspondence that the superintending archaeologist has indulged in, and also his conduct of the addressing the press for your kind judgment. Which means, you know, because I have been, giving press statements to the press also. So, of course, the Honorable Chief Minister was, very much worried about it also. And now a letter which goes from a chief minister to a central minister, action has to be taken because, you know, now my fate is completely sealed. I knew it is coming, closer than what I just thought. And for me now, there is no other way except to recite this one, Mahamrityunjay Mantra. Iske alawa aur koi rasta nahi, because you know the chief minister was after my blood, and we were expecting any moment it may come. But you know, somehow the whole press was with me. The entire press in Madhya Pradesh, national press was with me. All the channels were with me. When some of NDTV, Kumar Shekhar, he went to the whole place and he collected a lot of material. And he supported me. Then the press supported me. So there was full support from the press and from the general public also. And that saved me. And the press people, they went to Ambika Soni. And they asked me, show cause notice was of course issued to me. I said that this one, because I was so much passionately attached to my temples. And I knew that as a government servant, I should not have done it. And that is, I'm on the wrong side of this one also, but there was no other way of getting it stopped. You can send letters to anybody or to any people, but you know, it's not going to stop. And this was the only way how to get it stopped. So, and you can take action against me as I had done, committed a mistake against the rules. And all the press people were with me, the press group itself, they went to the Ambika Soni. And Ambika Soni had also, I think, by that time decided that no action is going to be taken. And what she did is, instead of punishing me, then in 2008, I mean, this Commonwealth Games were coming in Delhi. So she wanted somebody who could deliver things within time. So madam, this one transferred me to that place, but not immediately. Immediately she did not, because you know, then that would have given a very wrong signal. And the whole IBN 7, everyone were with me. I think I had taken a lot of time. Now, in 2015, Madhya Pradesh government, they invited all the IAS, IPS officers who were posted in Chambal Valley, in that Chambal commissionery. Even they had not seen a Chambal group like this one. Bateshwar ka mandir ko dekh chauke officer. Excellent. Ye unke command tha. Shandar. Excellent. Ye shabd Bateshwar mein. शिव मंदिरों को समूह को देखकर उन आईएएस आईपीएस अधिकारियों के मुंह से निकले जो 80 टेंपल्स देखने के बाद, क्योंकि दे हैड नेवर सीन, क्योंकि जगह पे जा भी नहीं सकता था उस जमाने में, इवन दो दे वेर आईएएस एंड आईपीएस ऑफिसर. अब नाउ नंबर ऑफ पीपल आर कमिंग फ्रॉम वेरियस पार्ट्स ऑफ द कंट्री. ये दिल्ली के लोग हैं, पूरा मंदिर को स्टडी करने के लिए वहां से लोग आ रहे हैं. This is from Holland, a group is coming, and they had won the Olympics Games in 2012. Olympics, Dutch Holland group. This is, I mean, wahin jaake jana baithe hue in logon ne photo khichwaya the. Then there was a team to explain to them. Ab yahi wahi team hai, I mean, 2012 mein jana they had won the Olympics game. So number of people are now coming. It has become a beautiful tourist place now. अभी मैं मध्य प्रदेश गवर्नमेंट ने 2 महीना पहले मैंने उनसे कहा कि यहाँ एक डकॉइट म्यूजियम बना दीजिए, क्योंकि डकॉइट म्यूजियम यू हैव गॉट सच म्यूजियम, इट्स इन इंग्लैंड इज देयर, इट इज इन स्पेन देयर, इट इज इन वेरियस कंट्रीज, आई मीन दिस काइंड्स ऑफ डकॉइट म्यूजियम्स आर देयर, रॉबिन हुड म्यूजियम इज देयर इन इंग्लैंड. उसी तरीके का एक म्यूजियम बना दीजिएगा, बिकॉज दिस म्यूजियम, दिस चंबल वैली, ऑल्दो पीपल फ्रॉम साउथ इंडिया, लाइक जब हम लोग जाते थे ट्रेन में जाते थे कि तो वो चिटकनी लगाता था, बड़ा डर लगता था. सो पीपल हैव हर्ड अबाउट दिस वन, ऑलमोस्ट मोर देन 30 फिल्म्स हैव पॉपुलराइज द एंटायर थिंग. शोले है, डकॉइट क्यों है, ये सब इतना पॉपुलराइज किया है, लोगों ने ये जगह देखा नहीं है. सो जस्ट टेक देम टू दिस पीपल, रूरल टूरिज्म आप वही इंट्रोड्यूस कीजिए. देयर आर 3 टेंपल ग्रुप, एक तो मेरा ये मंदिर का ग्रुप है, बटेश्वर का है. Then Padavali is there. Then Mitavali is there. Mitavali is almost like a this one. It's like a Parliament House. The naksha of Parliament House was taken from there. Chausat Yogini ka mandir. Chausat Yogini mandir. Jahan par bhi hoga, it would be a kind of circular term. Yes, sab hai. Yes, na government ko rural tourism mein include karke ek bahut acha museum bana denge. So I just submitted the report also, and I think government is seriously thinking of it also. क्योंकि वहां आप इंग्लैंड में बाकी जगह पे एक एडवर्टाइजमेंट दे दीजिए दैट यू विल बी हैविंग योर लंच टुडे विद सो एंड सो डकॉइट. क्योंकि अभी बहुत सारे डकॉइट्स ऐसे हैं कि जो सरेंडर डकॉइट्स हैं. सो यू कैन मेक मनी लाइक एनीथिंग, बट द गवर्नमेंट हैज टू थिंक ऑफ इट. द टूरिज्म मिनिस्टर, दिस वन कल्चरल मिनिस्टर, दे हैव टू हैव अ प्लान लाइक दिस वन. सो डकॉइट्स हेल्प प्रिजर्व मरीना टेम्पल्स, रेस्टोर्ड ग्लोरी. दिस इज मलबे में मंदिरों का खजाना, ग्वालियर के पास 14 टेम्पल सेफ, सीएम टेल सोनी, बट मोहम्मद में फेस हीट. अब मेरी बारी है. एएसआई टर्न्स टू आरएसएस, गेट्स हेल्प, वांटेड इलीगल माइनिंग टू बी स्टॉप नियर बटेश्वर टेम्पल्स, इलीगल माइनर्स फायर एट कलेक्टर एंड एसपी. इतना पावरफुल ग्रुप था, वो कलेक्टर को भी एसपी को भी फायर किया. So what is a poor superintending archaeologist? Some log jo na 3-4 log aise jaate the, दे कुड हैव इजीली फिनिश्ड अस, लेकिन सम लोग सिर्फ इसलिए बच गए कि आई मीन डकॉइट्स वेयर देयर डकॉइट्स व्हेन दे रीक देयर रिवेंज दे नो व्हाट वी हैव डन देयर व्हेन दे रीक देयर रिवेंज यू नो दे विल बी नॉट ओनली किलिंग द पर्सन हु हैड किल्ड मी बट दे वुड बी कंप्लीटली वाइपिंग आउट देयर फैमिली. तो इसलिए हम लोग जो ना सुरक्षित रहे बच गए. सुदर्शन जी की पहल पर शासन जागा, खदाने बंद, बटेश्वर की मंदिर बचाए. सरसंचालक सुदर्शन जी को पुरातत्व विभाग ने लिखा पत्र. मोहम्मद ने क्यों लिखा सुदर्शन को खत? सीएम ने उठाए एसआई अधीक्षक पर सवाल. माय वे ऑफ वर्किंग वाज क्वेश्चन बाय द चीफ मिनिस्टर, बट लेट अस द ऑनरेबल चीफ मिनिस्टर, ही रियलाइज्ड परहैप्स हिज मिस्टेक आल्सो. And he declared an award also for me, but I could not receive it because by that time I had minute-to-minute work at Delhi because of that Commonwealth, and I had to receive this one French president in Qutub Minar. So, wahi tha, and I may to bach gaya, but not this young IPS officer. Ye inko inhone bahut puri tarike se mara. The mining group jo na itna powerful tha ki inko jo na because wo illegally mine tractor ke niche laga ke jo na bahut kuchal ke mara bahut buri tarike se. He was I mean grind it into powder bahut. His name is Dhanendra Umar. Bedam banduk bekhauf mafia sirf ek hi saal mein ho chuke hai 50 se zyada hamle. To main मेरे बेटे की हत्या एक साजिश, तो मैं तो बच गया. आई गॉट दिस सार्क इंटरनेशनल अवार्ड फॉर दिस वर्क. ऑल द सार्क ग्रुप पीपल आर सिटिंग देयर. गुलजार साहब ने दिया. देयर इज अ वेरी पावरफुल लेडी अजित कौर मैडम. अजित कौर मैडम इज ऑर्गेनाइजिंग दिस काइंड ऑफ थिंग्स. वेरी 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 सोशल वर्कर, ग्रेट सोशल वर्कर. ये फिर आपको मालूम है it is from Madras, this one. And my wife, when she is receiving the award for the chief minister for this one, ye work was not going on since the last almost 10 years. Everything has been now come to a grinding halt. Humne socha ki BJP ke aane ke baad kuch hoga, kuch bhi nahi hai. So we are all very critical. And this is Mohar Singh, whom you had seen it earlier. Abhi inhone fir chitti likha. Kuch log unse jaake mile. Baba, aapne kam se kam chitti likhe de di. These people are from Gurjar community. Unhone chitti likha. Mujhe bhi bhej diya copy. And this is, I was frustrated because, you know, I mean, you thought a lot of things that BJP will do, but they are not at all bothered about it. Then one day I received a phone call from, this is, you might be knowing Sudha Murthy, wife of Narayan Murthy of this one, Infosys.
Yeah.
Yes, Infosys. One day madam received, phoned me and told me, Muhammad, I have been this one hearing a lot of things about you and about your work. I would like to see those things. And this is Deshpande ji, unki sister ki husband hai. It is he who is running all the Akshay Patras of America, the food thing. And the unke do teesri behan hai, to hum log sare family aapke sath chalna chahenge. To last February mein hum log janme, I took them to all this side group, aur unhone dekha, and they were again, I mean, bahut impress hua ye sab dekh ke. Ye sab jo hai na, and we had done the entire thing. 80 mandir abhi jo humne khada kar diya hai wo 3 crore rupees mein. To government of India ko ek 8 crore jo na baki ke liye spend karna kuch bhi nahi hai. And especially when you say that you have got such a BJP government, you speak about the glorious civilization, gaurushali itihas ke bare mein sab jo na lecture dete hai, lekin amal mein nahi aate. This is my criticism. काम करना चाहिए. यू हैव टू हैव इनोवेटिव आइडियाज, यू हैव टू कम फॉरवर्ड. ये सब जो ना कि वो जो ना हमारे पास पुष्प विमान था, हमारा ये पास जो ना सर्जरी आते थे, ये सब जो ना कह के जो ना इन सब चीजों से कोई फायदा नहीं है. कम टू एक्शन फील्ड एंड डू थिंग्स. तो मैडम ने आने के बाद जो ना भाई फिर कुछ दिनों के अंदर हम लोगों ने वी स्टार्टेड वर्किंग ऑन दिस वन. So government has got a project known as National Cultural Fund करके, उसमें मैडम ने कहा मैं I will contribute to that and let them take it up. तो एक मंदिर के लिए, फिर भी मंदिर बचा हुआ है. तो लेकिन तब तक तो कोविड आ गया, रुक गया है. So let it abate then. If the government is not coming, it should have been, ideally government should have come. And there is no dearth of money. Because I have been in so many tourism committees and I know how money is being wasted by any government. Now after the coming of BJP, in cultural field, it has gone back. Because especially this one, Pragya Prabhav, people should listen to it. Because it was better than Congress. Congress didn't stop the work. Because when I was the superintending archaeologist, I had 25 lakh ka power. Tha. Woh 25 lakh ka power use karte hui 80 mandir khada kar diya hai. Lekin aaj ek superintending archaeologist ka haath mein 3 lakh ka power hai. Ye 3 lakh rupees se woh kya karenge? And everything has to go to Delhi. Ab BJP ke aane ke baad. Uske pehle aisa nahi tha. So Congress was far, far better. Ye internally hum log sab feel kar rahe hai aaj. Ye aapko sunana खरी कोटी सुनाना भी हम लोगों की ये है, क्योंकि वरना यू नो थिंग्स आर नॉट चेंजिंग. हम तो बस अपना गौरवशाली इतिहास के बारे में बात करेंगे, लेकिन व्हाट इज द एक्शन? कुछ नहीं है. सारे हर जगह पे पिछले 6 साल से काम बंद हो गया है. सिर्फ बाउंड्री वॉल और इसमें चल रहा है, इन विच दे हैव गॉट सर्टेन फायदा भी है. तो दिस इज अगेन सुहानिया, मैंने ले जाके दिखाया, किसी भी टाइम में गिर सकते. गवर्नमेंट का कौन सी इतना बड़ा प्रॉब्लम मेरा समझ में नहीं आ रहा है. ये मैं आपको थोड़ा सा हटके दिखा रहा हूँ. कैन आई टेक 10 मिनट्स?
या आई थिंक लेट्स क्लोज इट फास्ट बिकॉज़ अदर्स वुड वांट टू आस्क यू सम क्वेश्चंस सर.
दैट्स बी बेटर. ठीक है, मैं एकदम थोड़ा सा 5 मिनट ले लूंगा फिर.
श्योर.
स्लम स्कूल के बारे में है ये. व्हेन आई वाज इन दिल्ली, बहुत सारे वर्कर्स मेरे साथ थे, इनके बच्चों को कभी पढ़ने का मौका नहीं मिलता था. तो मैं उनको क्या करता था, ये चौराहे में भीख मांगने के लिए चले जाते थे. आई थिंक ऑल पीपल कैन फॉलो हिंदी और आई मीन
या बट देन प्रोबब्ली इंग्लिश इज बेटर.
अच्छा, ओके. सो दे व्हेन पीपल आई मीन दे वर गोइंग टू दिस वन नियर बाय चौराहा फॉर बेगिंग आर्म्स. सो व्हाट आई डिड इज आई हैव स्टार्टेड द स्मॉल schools. I mean, wherever the parents are working, hundreds of laborers were there. So just give them food, just give them a uniform, teach them Hindi, English, mathematics. Although government has got so many projects for this one, you know, it never comes to the gareeb logon ke paas, it never goes to the poor people. So it is where, I mean, RSS, Pragya Prabhav can do a meaningful work. Whatever are those areas, you know, you consider. Yeah, it was not always, I mean, you had no shade. Sometimes it was in an open field. Sometimes there was a tent. So it was opposed by some of the higher officers. So I said that I am spending money out of my own pocket. It's not the government money. We are not using any kind of government money. It is, I mean, they are staying there and I'm just giving them this one in the English. And there are many people who were donating money in kind. Just give them some few facilities like this one. I mean, many people from Delhi and other people, social workers, it is in Safdarjung tomb. With very, very, very little bit of money you can. They never had a watch, you know. Just give them a watch. इसी तरीके के मकान में रहते हैं, गिव देम अ काइंड ऑफ दिस वन फैसिलिटीज. सर्वे भवन्तु सुखिनां, सर्वे सन्तु. वी रिसाइट ऑल दिस थिंग्स लेकिन अमल में नहीं लाते. वी डोंट प्रैक्टिकलाइज इट. एंड समटाइम्स यू नो द स्टूडेंट्स विल बी मोर बिकॉज फ्रॉम द सराउंडिंग एरियाज आल्सो पीपल विल कम टू माय स्कूल. एंड कंबल देना है माय वाइफ, आई मीन शी वाज इन चार्ज ऑफ फंड. सो शी distributing funds, kambals. And there are many people who had joined us. It is in Qutub Minar. And now they came with this one idea. This one, now these parents also wanted to learn. So sometimes, you know, their classes will be along with their children. And unka the it should be during the night time also. So I mean, during the night time they had to prepare food. I said that we'll give you food, and I started giving food also. And just see how with 1 year, 2 year bachchon ke saath aate hain. And again, now these people, they have learned Hindi, they are now learning English. And many people, this is Mrs. Neera Mishra, she's running an organization known as Draupadi and doing a lot of social work. And this is a German lady who is, and this is Satish from, he's from Cananore, his wife is in English, and they wanted to help us. So I said that you give it in kind. This is Jain Sahab, Pavan Jain. It was he who was supplying all the material, kambal material from Delhi. He used to get it at a very low cost for us. Just see all this thing. And this, so CNN, IBN, they gave me an award. This was Citizen Journalist Award. And it was given by a man who was much taller than me. So it became famous. That was this man. So this, when this was seen by another taller man, a man taller than him, he also wanted to see these children. Just see who is that. That was this man. Barack Obama and Mrs. Obama. And he was the happiest man when he met these children. Just see the way he is sitting. And just see this child. His name is Vishal. It was Mr. Vishal who had gone and received him, a slum child gone and received, welcome Mr. and Mrs. Obama. So he was taken aback. And he remembered the name of the boy. His name is, he asked him, what is your name? He said, Vishal. And that was in 2010. In 2015, again, he came as the chief guest of our Republic Day parades. So just before coming, 6 days before, I had retired by that time. My school was wound up. And I got a phone call from American embassy that President of America is looking for Vishal. I had forgotten Vishal. So they told me that I should pin him down where he is. So I said, it's not possible because he's, I mean, neither email nor mobile. But then I had his father's Ramdas number. They were working with me in Delhi, but now he was working in Ujjain. So I mean, I contacted him, and then he met him. On 26th, he, of course, his program was that one. And on 27th, before meeting Tata, Birla, and all the business magnates, they met this boy and introduced him. He did not forget his past because of this one. And now this is the, when KK Momma received a phone call from US Embassy in New Delhi on 19th of July. And then when I went for a lecture in Delhi, I introduced him to Mata Sundari College. There was a huge gathering there in the college. I introduced him, and then they also contributed. I also contributed. We again helped him. So this way we had just given a push. Many of these boys, you know, slum boys, they had now, I mean, got a meaningful, some kind of livelihood. So this is how we can serve the society. He did not forget his past. So this is, I'm now coming to the end of my talk for this one. Got a lot of awards for this one. So, I mean, all this for various works in the country. And this was the final award for this one. So thank you all. Thank you very much. And very patient, very giving a very patient hearing. And we will be able to do many things by this one. I mean, without spending much money, you know, there are ways and means, you know, by which we can do, and we can do a very meaningful work for the country and also conserve and preserve the rich heritage of the country. And I am hopeful that Pragya Prabha will not only listen to me, because, you know, that is what I am finding in many of the BJP associated this one organization. They don't, when they have to say, no, this has to be done, they don't do that one. They will be listening, very good listeners, and at the same time, action, no action. So thank you all, sir. Thank you very much. Now you can ask me question, and I have got some more things against you, but not at this time. Yeah, not at this time.
Okay. So you can stop screen share, sir.
Yeah.
I think just a big pranamam to Apara Brahma. I think what you have done is just amazing. I think, you know, many, many generations owe it to you for the great work that you have done for bringing back the glory of Bharat and its, you know, all its splendor and grandness. When there were Muhammad of Ghazni and Muhammad of Ghori who destroyed our temples, we have another Muhammad who is painstakingly building it back. And, you know, we are very proud of you, sir. We are extremely proud of you. And thank you. The only word we can use is thank you. And we'll do our best in terms of, you know, trying to take your message forward. I understand the challenges. You know, your frustration is something which we all share. In the last 5-6 years, we did have significant amount of challenges where we are unable to, you know, make things move on the culture and archaeology field.
Yes.
We in Pragya Pravaha and Pragya Bharati, we always felt that the most powerful ministry in the government is the archaeological department.
Yes, yes, yes.
Because your history and your culture is one what defines you. Otherwise, the rest of it is all administrative babus who do it. I mean, you are the one who have actually brought back the culture of this land, which was in ruins. And, you know, I was choked, actually. I was struggling for words. Thank you. Thank you so much, sir. I think we'll just open it up for questions. But then I have a few questions before I throw it open to people. Already we have a lot of people who have raised their hands. I, as an amateur, have also traveled, you know, to many, many archaeological sites, especially prehistorical sites, or as they are called, you know, the Saraswati civilization related or Vedic civilization related. So many sites I went, Birana, Rakhigadi, Kalibangan, and you name it. So I've gone to a lot of these places. I think as a nation, as a people, we are completely apathetic and we don't care for our culture.
Yes.
All these sites are in such pathetic situation. I mean, you're seeing a civilization which is worth, I mean, which lasted 7,000 years back.
Yes.
3,500, 4,000 BC. Birana is the oldest site. It is about 7,000 BC. Whereas there are buffaloes and there are just, you know, cow dung and, you know, nobody cares for it. Whereas even a site which is 100, 200 years old in the Western world, they mint money. You know, you have tourism, they paid $20, $30, $50 to go see some nonsense, which is good for nothing. People go to Singapore to see a lion statue spitting water. What is that? Nothing compared to the glorious temples that you have reconstructed, sir. So I think we as a nation, we are completely disconnected with our culture. And the passion with which you have done and gone out of your way to even knock at the doors of Sarsang Chalak Ji to protect your temples is amazing. I think you're just not a great professional archaeologist, but you're a great Bharatiya. And so we really salute you for what you have done, sir. Why do you think successive governments since independence have not changed a comma or a full stop in the archaeological manual? I mean, it is so stupid. I mean, you go to any archaeological sites, let's say I go to Khajuraho, I can't use a tripod, right? Whereas I can have a camera, I can shoot whatever I want. But if I want to have a tripod, I need to get a permission from Delhi. You know, all archaeological sites, this is a problem. The rules are all something laid down during the British era. Nothing has changed. And the kind of administrative misuse we are doing in terms of an archaeologist, we use them for conservation. A conservationist, we use it for, you know, museum upkeep. We are misusing the talent that is there in our department. Why do you think the government, the people, and this nation has been so apathetic to our culture? What is your reading about it, sir? It's not about a single government, but so many governments for so many decades. Yes. Why is it like this? And what should we do?
Earlier, we could have said, all the sites, including this one, Hastinapura, is in a very deplorable condition. All over the Kalibanga, as you said,
And Hastinapur site, you can't make out. It's completely of shrubs, bushes and all. Yes. The trench where BB Lalji dug up, completely covered with plants and trees, and you can't even make out. Whereas even now, the pottery sheds are shown coming out of that mud. The pottery sheds are 1500, 2000 years back. 2000 BC.
See, for all these things, we are, all the places are in a very deplorable conditions. You could have, there was a shortage of funds also, but now it is not like that. Right from 2003 onwards, I don't think there is any shortage of fund. The only thing is, you don't deal with things the way you should have done. There was one minister that was Jagmohan Ji. He was a minister who had that kind of passion for doing the work and implementing the work. He used to directly talk to each of us. And you need that kind of ministers. You don't need any kind of, this minister, minister or that minister. You have to have a man who is passionate in the field. Unless and until you have a passionate man in the field, you cannot do. Similarly, a director general also. They have to have some kind of feeling. This is my own culture. This is my own heritage. How many officers have we have got that one? And how many ministers you have got? Last time also we had in one of the recommendations, because similarly there were a few director generals also. I said there was one of the IAS officer and he was from a Karnataka group, and within 1 year he completely overhauled the archaeological survey. And this time also I requested some of the people, here is a man who can do a lot of things. So why can't you give this one to him? But there was no support for all these things. No support. So that is the biggest thing. That is what we'll have to take up all these things through Pragya Prabha, through Sanskar Bharati also. And you should make yourself, your sound heard. It is not being heard. And I complained this thing very frustratingly to RSS also. But somewhere it is stuck up. It was half done and then it was stuck up. So, and the ASA has gone back to the same rut. That is what I said. Congress was far, far better. At least they did not interfere in things. So we could do whatever we want. And we had that freedom also. But now there is no financial freedom. Everything is completely brought into a grinding halt. It is like a painted boat on a painted wall since the last 6 years.
Very sad.
I wrote about it. Even, we are not critics. We may not be following the party ideology, but at the same time, it is we are supporting at various places. So at least listen to the people who are, passionate about all this. That is also not there.
Absolutely.
And it goes like this one, within 5 years, many of this monument will be developing crack. Yeah. And we know why they are doing this one. Because, the integrity is now being doubted because of this kind of attitude.
That is very sad. I think for us, the loyalty has to be the glory of Bharat.
Yes,
and
yes.
Parties or organizations all come later.
Yes.
I think Bharat first and everything else next.
Yes, yes.
Yeah. And then one more question, sir.
And that RK's rules also, that has to be changed. Even we have been feeling, we have been saying, so that is why we thought that if that person who had come, then we, many things,
Can you recommend what needs to be changed? I'm sure you've written a lot of letters.
Yes.
Maybe you can share them with us. And what are your suggestions in terms of what should be done with the Archaeological Survey of India? And what's the kind of technology that is needed? For instance, I believe when Vasant Shindeji wanted to do something on Rakhi Gadi DNA, they had to send it to Singapore or something like that. We didn't have the technology to map some of the stuff here.
Yes.
So if you could share with us,
yes,
what are the administrative changes that are needed in the policy level of archaeological manual, and what is the new technology that Bharat needs to introduce? If you can share with us, we as Pragya Bharati, we promise you that we will take it up with the ministry or whoever concerned. From our side, we will try and put our own pressure as well.
But then you will be a frustrated man like me. Fair enough, sir.
You'll have company.
Okay. That's good.
Thank you. So now I'm inviting Srinivas Rauji. Srinivas Rauji has got a book, your book translated in Telugu, and they're willing to launch it anytime soon.
Srinivas Rauji is here.
Yeah, he's there.
Sir.
Great.
Yes. I'm just unmuting him, so you can.
Is the present surprise, sir?
Yes, sir. The first point I want to make to this group is I have respect for Dr. K.K. Mohammed, not as an archaeologist, not for the temples, not for the monuments he worked, but in my opinion, he is the most evolved human being that I met in India in my recent visits, and therefore I consider that he is in the forefront of human evolution, not just India. By the way, to say that, I have a PhD in molecular genetics from University of Paris.
Okay, so let's
then.
I think Srinivas Bhagaru, if I request you,
it's a pleasant surprise for me.
There are others also on the line.
Sure.
So let's continue. Close it fast, yeah, please.
That's all. No. My point is, all those who are 50s, 60s in the positions in the government may or may not listen to him, but if his story is read by millions in India, the country will change at least in the next 10, 20 years. And it is not in English, and therefore I got the Malayalam book and translated into Telugu, and we are releasing that. And I am ready to release in every single language. And I have done my homework. Recently, I have translated everything in 13 languages. And therefore, I'm prepared, there is enough support, to release in all the languages that I can.
Right.
My 13 translators are ready, and Telugu is going on. I close with one last sentence. There's a doctor in Visakhapatnam. I sent this information to him. This is a busy doctor, COVID times, but every day he is sitting with me, reading every single word in that book and correcting it. You know what he said? The language of the book must change dramatically because the person whom you are presenting is of extraordinary nature. So the language also must match with that. With that, I close.
Thank you, sir. Can I now request Dr. Rudresh Pandeji to speak? Rudreshji, you can unmute yourself and talk. Yeah.
Thank you, sir. Sir, I want to ask you, what was the reason of destruction of these temples? And if they were destroyed, why was not those stone lost? You could recover almost 90% of those temples. So what was the reason for those British temples? Thank you, sir.
It was a huge earthquake in 14th century, because this earthquake had affected Qutub Minar also. And then during the time of Firoz Shah Tughlaq, they had taken up the conservation work of Qutub Minar. So it was exactly at that time, the whole area was completely affected. Had it been a kind of attack from an army, they would have mostly chopped off the facial portions, sometimes hands, sometimes necks and other parts also. So nothing of that kind had taken place. Only from some kind of fall that had affected. Otherwise, it was not damaged. All of them were in very good condition. So it was because of an earthquake in 14th century also. And then in 15th century also, there was earthquake like this one. So it was mainly because of that.
Suresh Kochatilji. Suresh ji, You can unmute yourself and talk.
Yes, sir. Mr. Mohammed, this is Suresh Kochhatil here.
Yes, sir.
And my question to you, I'm from Thrissur in Kerala, but I grew up in Hyderabad.
Achcha.
So my question to you is, there were thousands of temples which were destroyed in Kerala.
Yes.
I don't want to get into the history part of it, but you know who this
is. Yes, yes, yes.
And many of these temples are still languishing for lack of attention.
Yes, yes.
As much as you have restored temples in Madhya Pradesh and other places, some of the temples are very near to the place where you are living.
Yes, yes.
My question to you would be, there are some organizations which are actually renovating those temples and which goes back to hundreds of years.
Yes.
What is your opinion about restoring the remaining temples in Kerala? What do you think should be done? Who should be doing it?
No, there are, I think, some Tamil groups or Karnataka groups are there. And they are doing a very good work, I mean, in finding out all these places and taking up the conservation work also.
Reclaiming Temples Group. There's a group called Reclaiming Temples Group.
Yes, yes, sir.
Yeah. I heard about them, but I don't have any. I'm not in touch with them, nor they are with me. So, but I mean, it's a wonderful work they are doing. You know, I appreciate it because when somebody narrated me this thing that they are doing this one work, I said that, I mean, if they approach me, that we are ready to give all kinds of help and cooperation. But I'm not an expert in South Indian temple because I never had an opportunity to work in South India and especially in Kerala. I can work mostly in North India. North India, Shikara Temples group. Here, whatever we know that we can speak about them, and there are a number of opportunities to work in Kerala.
Thank you, sir.
Welcome.
Thank you. Mr. Amiruddin? Amiruddin ji, you can unmute yourself and then talk.
Hello.
Yeah.
मोहम्मद भाई, सबसे पहले बहुत अच्छा काम आपने किया, बहुत बहुत मुबारकबाद।
थैंक यू सर, थैंक यू।
मेरा सवाल दो क्वेश्चन है मेरे।
अच्छा।
कि जो हेरिटेज साइट पे जो आपने जो काम किया है, ठीक है, इससे इंडियन टूरिज्म को तो बढ़ावा मिलेगा वर्ल्ड वाइड, लेकिन जो अपने जो प्लूरलिस्टिक जो वैल्यू है उसको किस तरह से वो इम्पेक्ट करता है वो, ठीक है
सर।
और दूसरा क्वेश्चन ये है कि आप 2014 और 2016 दो तीन साल तक आप AKTC के साथ जुड़े हुए थे,
वो
भी कंजर्वेशन प्रोसेस है, तो उनके पास जो बेस्ट प्रैक्टिसेस जो होती है उनके साथ जो आपकी जो लर्निंग और जो ट्यूरिंग थी उसके बारे में कुछ पूछना चाहता
हूँ। ये तो खैर, तो ये है कि जो ना द गवर्नमेंट इट हैज गॉट इनफ अपॉर्चुनिटी टू मार्केट इट, बट द गवर्नमेंट इज नॉट डूइंग इट, दैट इज आवर कंप्लेंट। They can market it like anything, our you know, precious heritage that could be marketed like anything, but they are not doing it at all. And the second thing is, you know, this AKTC, I have been working with AKTC in Delhi also, of course in Hyderabad also, because in 7 tombs I worked along with them. So there are very good practices and they have got very good archaeologists also, they are very good conservators. And whatever help, I mean, whatever they are ready to help Archaeological Survey of India also. And it was in the initial say, it was Archaeological Survey of India who had helped them also. So it should be a kind of give and take. You know. With the help of give and take, we can do a lot of work. Now, earlier, I mean, we were only in 7 tombs there, but now we have extended to some other places also. So that the work is going on very well. They are doing, I mean, Aga Khan Trust is a great organization. They work not only in the field of conservation, but they also work in the field of education also for the poor. It's a great organization. You don't get that kind of organization.
Sure. Thank you, sir. Balaji Krishnamurthy.
Yeah. Hello, sir. Can you hear me?
Yeah, we can.
Yeah. So my first, I have a few questions. My first one is, can archaeology be a viable career option for youngsters when they decide which career path to choose? Say a young person, he may be interested in archaeology, but he may be discouraged due to finances and earning opportunity. So he may be passionate about archaeology, but is it enough to earn a living?
Yes, sir. This is enough to earn a living, But at the same time, it's not a very lucrative business. It's not a lucrative job also. So I don't recommend it for all the people, unless and until you have that kind of passion for the subject. You should not go for that one. Otherwise, you know, I mean, the whole future would be at block. You don't have that kind of opportunities in this one. Opportunities are very less. And that too, the whole thing is now completely saturated also. So unless and until one has got that kind of passion for the subject, we don't generally recommend it.
Yeah, so that is the sad part of it, is actually.
Yeah, that's the best part.
They should have been a very thriving field, and people should have been coming in large numbers.
Yes, but this could be done better if you are ready to market your heritage. Because it's underutilized. The whole Hastinapura, the whole Jana Kalibanga, all these places are great places. Just market it. It's like China is doing. We are blaming China, but I mean, the way they are doing it, why can't we also do it? All of some of the European countries.
Yeah, Kalibangan has the world's oldest ploughed field.
Oh, field.
And you have covered it up with a sheet and, you know.
Yes, yes.
And your road that goes to Kalibangan is so broken. I think the 5 kilometer stretch from Pilibangan takes about half an hour.
Yes, yes.
We are that pathetic in the whole, conservation. I'm with you on that. I mean, unless that is there, there is no career for people. I agree with you. Yeah. Next is Chandan Lohia ji. Please go ahead, sir.
Namaskar, KK sahab. First of all, my naman to you. You are doing really a very good job.
Thank you, sir. Thanks.
Great job. I daily morning send a small quip on some of the Indian temples, its architecture and everything. Around 6 days back, I had come across your post that in 3 crores, you have done 60 temples and you require 8 more crores.
Yeah.
After that, I have been writing to ASI, trying to get your address. And I think it is God sent that today I am able to have the good fortune of listening to you.
Sir.
So this is actually very good. We had wanted to know if are you also having any private organization which is working on this? Because few of our friends were thinking of crowdfunding and then assisting.
Yeah.
The renovation of such temples. And it is not just Madhya Pradesh, but we have found that there are so many temples all across the country.
Yeah.
Beautiful pieces, but lying in ruins just because ASI is not having enough funds or powers to touch them, and others are not bothered. So is there any private organization or anything in which you are also associated where we could assist in any way?
See, I mean, we have a national cultural fund is there. That is the Government of India fund. So if you wanted to take up any particular monument, you can give that funds to National Cultural Fund. And then they will be having their own person to get it implemented. And that is the best way of doing it, because an ASI means it would be at a very low cost. They would be able to do it at a shoestring budget, not other private organizations. So what we have to do is we have to tell the Government of India, you bring out this organization. The organization is there, the apparatus is there. The only thing is it's not working. You have to make it working. Then only, you know, funds can be utilized. There may not be any dearth of fund. Many people are ready to that, but you provide them a platform for them. That is what is lacking. That is what we are saying, that Government of India is not showing the kind of interest which they should have shown in this field, in this ministry. And that too, I again bracketed this 6 years. Earlier there was a thing that was going on, working on, but now it has come to a grinding halt, 6 years.
It is unfortunate. I will take details through our Girdharji on this organization, and hopefully we will be able to, as individual citizens, aid you or join you in this crusade. But again, my sincerest naman, you have really done a great work for the entire Bharat.
Yeah, yes, yes.
Thank you for this. As a common citizen, we all thank you for this.
Thank you, sir. Thank you.
Next is Bhaskar Sangoju.
Yes.
Bhaskar ji, please go ahead. Yeah. Bhaskar, you have to unmute it yourself. Yeah.
Sir, a wonderful presentation. I would like to know from the speaker, while restoration, what precautions or measures have been taken to protect from earthquake, these structures?
We have not taken any extraordinary measures in this one. The only thing is that we have given a deep foundation, because you know, we had a lot of fund constraints also within which we had to work. So these are not huge temples. So again, you may not be having that big problem, because then if they are very big temples of 11th and 12th century, because 11th and 12th century, you have huge temples like the great Brihadishvara or the Konark temple or the Khajuraho temples. These are smaller temples, mostly 15 feet, or sometimes you know, it would be 20 feet, not more than that one. So it doesn't suffer much from that kind of earthquake.
But your initial remarks, you said the destruction could have been due to earthquake.
Ah, yes. At that time, because they were not using very good binding material at that time.
Achha.
The binding material, because in South India, if you come to Tamil Nadu, there is a locking system is there. There will be a point and then there will be a depression. So within that, it locks. That kind of locking system was also not there. And here, they were not having very good binding material also. Only mud was used as binding material. But what we have done is, now what we have given is that lime mortar. So lime, you had to soak them for 21 days in the water.
Okay.
And then we have to mix it them with the surki.
Achha.
And then dal patar ki, urud ki dal.
Okay.
That is a kind of pulse. So you have to mix it with that also. Then the white portion of eggs, suppose you wanted to have a very fine plaster, then you have to mix it with white portion of the milk also, egg, then the milk. So all this is it's known as Mughal shell lime plaster. So you can use it as a plaster also, you can use it as a binding material also. Once you use this one, then of course its life is more than 500, 600 years. Whereas the cement is only 65 or 80 years. So this is the kind of building material which we have used it, I mean, for this conservation work.
Thank you, sir. I think cement is not a good compatible material.
No, we don't use cement. We use only traditional material for this.
Okay.
We don't use cement at all.
And you also said one more point, the GPR. So what kind of works you use the GPR, sir, here? And what is that frequency of antenna you use?
No, the GPR survey, we don't use it. We give it to some kind of agencies for that one. Because it's a completely specialized area. For example, for the excavation of Ayodhya, it was Tojo Vikas. When this one 1992, when it was demolished, then there was any kind of structural remains below the mosque. So before excavation, Archaeological Survey of India had given this thing, assigned these things to Tojo Vikas, that is a Canadian company. So in which they came to know there are a number of structures because of the anomalies. Because if it is only mud and mud, you know, there will not be any kind of anomaly. But if there are structures, there will be anomalies. It is on the basis of that one. So whatever data they provide, we just take it them. Otherwise, you know, we are not expert in that one. We are only experts in archaeological excavations and conservations.
And for this temple complex, did you do any consolidation for the soil? Means foundation part?
No, the foundation part, we gave a depth of this one. For the foundation, we gave a depth of 2 meters.
Achha.
Otherwise, you know, we don't use raft foundations also.
Okay. Okay.
In some places where the soil capacity is not very good, there we use this kind of raft foundation. For example, in other part of Madhya Pradesh, where you have got that black cotton soil, there we use, when I transplanted one temple, that is, it is known as Sauvi Saudar temple.
Okay.
That Achyutam Keshavam, Ramanarayanam, Krishnadamodaram, Vasudev. When we completed that one, transplanted that temple from its original place to a distance of 5 kilometers, there we use this kind of raft foundation.
Okay.
Otherwise, we don't use it.
Okay. Thank you. Thank you, sir.
Welcome,
sir. Thank you, Oscar. Thank you. Next is Kishore Dattuji.
Namaste, Mohammed Saab. First of all, I'm too small to praise the work that you are doing. So I'm falling short of words. Only pranam to you. So my question is, I mean, in the past, when these kings built these big, big, amazing temples and all the infrastructure that they built, one of the prime objective was to bring the different communities together, and also that was a source of employment. Now, over the period of time, especially, you know, after the independence and all that, do you think the negligence towards that department was lack of, because it does not really create employment in that sense? And in this case, if it is true, I think I'm taking it's a continuation to what my previous participant was saying, Chandanji was saying. Is there a possibility that we can offset this department as a public-private and invest more into private people, so more people can come in and make it as a employment generation department as such? Is it a possibility, or is this just a not really good idea?
I know it is a very good idea. The government should change its mindset. We should change our mindset. It can enormous employment. It can create enormous employment. It can create the whole tourism department that is meeting out that. I mean, the GDP is 12% of the 8% of GDP is coming out from tourism. And the entire tourism, 90% of tourism depends upon this archaeological monuments of the government of India and the state monuments. But for that monuments, they will not spend any money. For the conservation of the monument means it is not only the physical conservation, it is the spiritual conservation also. So they don't, whichever government comes, you know, because they don't just bother about it. And that is what I am telling. I mean, Pragya Prava, Sanskara Bharati, they have got an extraordinary duty now, at least during this period. Okay, let us say that, I mean, during the earlier period, we were not having that kind of approach. But at least now we have. And why we have gone back? It is in minus. Congress was doing well, very well. That is what I am telling you. Congress was far, far better than BJP government in this one. And it is completely gone back. Like, it is in minus. So there we have to say no. It is not the proper way of doing things. Otherwise, I mean, this could come in. You have to have a very resourceful IAS officers also. Very thinking, because you know, if you go to Delhi, there I have made a museum. This museum is known as a replica museum. A man who comes to Delhi, he sees Qutub Minar, this one, Lal Killa, and Humayun Tomb. They think it is only Mughal monument. Go to Agra, again, so the same Taj Mahal and other thing. Go to this place, Jaipur, you call it Rajput monument, they are the same Mughal monument. So a man goes with an idea, no, this is only Mughal monuments. But what about our Brahadishara? What about our Hampi, the great Hampi, this one, Narasimha statue? What about our Buddha of this one, Sarnath? All these things are...
Kailash temple of Ellora.
Ellora, yes. Ravana shaking Kailash. And what I have done is, I did not show you those things. I have made a replica museum in Delhi itself. And at that time, it was a Congress government, so people said it's a BJP idea. I said I am neither BJP nor Congress, but it is an Indian idea. And I thought that there will be some support, little support, when the BJP comes. But BJP people were not at all bothered about it. You go this one, Siri Fort Auditorium, just behind the Fort Centenarium, I had won 35 lakhs of rupees by readjusting that 35 lakhs of rupees. I have made a museum, beautiful museum, again on a very shoestring budget. If you go to the bazaar, it will be, each one would be costing 9 lakhs. But I have made it with 90,000 rupees by using the students of Fine Arts College of Patna College. So, is there a lot of things that we can do? Dr. Srinivasa Rao Saab's idea is a very big idea. अब उसके बारे में मेरे ख्याल में राव साहब जो ना खुद आपसे बात करेंगे. Because I mean, you have to have this, that kind of new ideas, innovative ideas. Usko jana logon ka samne rakhiyega. You can sell this country like anything. We can market this country like anything. But that kind of innovative people with innovative ideas do not come. Or if at all they come, they don't come to the proper place. And always we have got a wrong man at the right place.
Yeah, this is a very sad reflection of missing out on many things, but I think there has to be a reality check on this. Definitely, yes. Dr. Gauri Shankar.
Yes. Yes. Hello.
Hi, sir.
Are you hearing me, sir?
Yes, you can.
Sir, for one thing, I want to congratulate you, and I had to be very very much grateful to you for your work. That is point number one. And two questions I want to put from my end. The thing is, if you know, in previously there was a huge conflict in the Sabarimala issue, means allowing the ladies in that aspect, one issue took part. So sure. In that part, I want to know that can archaeology department helps in that particular thing. The thing is, according to the literature that I am having, is one saint at 1820 who resides at Godavari area of Andhra Pradesh. He opened. He gave a statement which is a recorded one, stating that the son of Ayyappa and Malika Pratamba will be Kalki. So for that which in order to get good tapas, he is having a lot of tapas to give
up. Dr. Gauri Shankar ji, see, this is a subject. What you're asking is more of an interpretation of some text. That is not the job of an archaeologist. I think you're asking a wrong question. This is nothing to do with archaeology. Okay.
Okay. Second question is, can archaeology department give any idea that in that particular period of time, what will be the food habits of that particular area people? Can archaeology department give that idea? Because one of my friends who is a doctor doing something in that particular aspect, she wants the information like that.
Okay. Thank you.
Archaeology department give the idea that what is the food habit in that particular period.
Okay, sure. Thank you.
Of course, I mean, because if you there is a method for this paleobotanical archaeological investigations are there. It's again, I mean, a different set of people who are specialized in paleobotany. They look at the soil, they collect the sample, and then they look at what are the grains at that time we had used at that time. So that is again a very specialized branch, but in forest area that would be very difficult also sometimes, you know, to get various things because of the abundant rain, everything washes off. So it is a very difficult proposition, but it could be done. It could be done, but it's a very difficult proposition sometimes in areas where you have got enough rain, because whatever formation is there, soil formation is there, that is completely washed out during the next rain. So there are problems, but it could be done.
Thank you, sir. Ravi Krishna ji, friends, I think we need to ask questions fast. We are running out of time. It's already quite late. So I would request all of you to be very brief. Ravi Krishna ji, please unmute and you can talk.
Namaste, sir.
Namaskar.
I would like to ask one small question, sir.
There is an echo coming from your voice. Yeah.
Small question, sir.
How
do you visualize exactly how it was earlier when you have shown all the temples in a particular format?
Yeah.
When the entire thing is mess,
yeah.
How do you accumulate such knowledge in it was earlier like this position or this position?
Very good question. Actually, very fortunately, we have got certain this one. Ancient treaties are there on temple architecture of each area. For example, if it is in Kerala, that is Tantra Samuchayam. If it is in North India, there are three groups. One is Manasara, then Mayamada. This was from 9th century onwards, which was as per Mayamada. And then there is another known as this one, Samarangana Sutradhara, that was written by Raja Poch. So they give this one also description also, and we get some kind of diagrams also from that book. And then there were certain temples which was standing also. Now, on the basis of all these things, it is easy for a man who study about this temple architecture of earlier period also, later period also, and then, I mean, 11th and 12th century, that is the medieval period also. It is very easy to reconstruct. There is no problem with the help of all these things. So you have to have a combination of the books also, and then the living examples also.
Have we codified such a, whatever you have accumulated knowledge, it is with an experience only.
Yeah.
Have you codified such knowledge into any some books like that?
It's already there. Actually, we have drawn on those books. Future generation. We have drawn on those books because we have taken the help of those books also. And then our practical experience is also there. And you know, even our laborers are now very well experienced. They do the work, you know, they know, suppose they get a stone, they would be able to tell you whether it is Kura or Kumbha or Kalasha. They would be able to tell you. It needs some kind of experience for that. I mean, it takes a time, but you know, within few, 2-3 months, you know, you will also be an expert in that.
Sir, but have you written any book on this temples? I mean, your entire experience of restoring the 60 and odd temples. Have you written any book or something like that?
I'm doing it now because it may take some more time. I'm doing it now.
Yeah. Okay, great.
You deserve Bharat Ratna, sir.
Yes, sir.
Thank you.
If they do this thing, you know, what we have been discussing, that would be the greatest Bharat Ratna. Because, you know, there is a lot of things to be done. And opportunity is there, but it has been misused and it is not in the right direction. That is our greatest Bharat Ratna for all of us.
Well said, sir. Fantastic. I think that is a better thing than you know what Delhi can ever recognize. It's the future generations and it's the people who are going to actually respect you. Great. Bhanu Vashisht ji, please go ahead. Yeah.
प्रणाम मोहम्मद साहब बहुत बहुत चरण वंदना और आज मुझे अजीब सा लगा भाई संजन्स की प्रज्ञा सभा आपका ये प्रोग्राम करवा रही है तो बहुत ही संक्षेप में दो तीन सवाल फर्स्ट थिंग इज कि जो आपका स्किल लेवल है उसको पास ऑन करने के लिए इज देयर सम इंस्टीट्यूशनल वे वेयर परहैप्स आर्किटेक्ट्स आल्सो कुड बी टॉट अबाउट दिस लाइक आर्किटेक्ट BR, CMARC, there should be one semester,
yes,
some chapter you should be, or you know, archaeologists should be taking one thing.
Yes.
Because there is a lot of knowledge perhaps which people won't be able to study so many books as probably you have studied that are sitting behind you in the library.
Yeah.
Anji. Second thing is, since you said that there is a dearth of money which government is willing to spend, I'm very sure there are answers other than the government. So, are you or your team working on something where funds could be generated? Because people are willing to spend funds, but are you through some agency working on something like this? I'll be very happy to know. After this convention, if I could probably get in touch with you over the mail or phone.
Yes.
This is second. Hanji. And third thing, we are a group of individuals. We started a small movement, but we are gaining some pace. We would like to invite you to certain sessions or webinars and, you know, in on certain platforms in, you know, in India or in US, which are connected to Sanatan Dharma and the great service you have done. So I would be very happy to take it forth also, ji.
Surely, I mean, we can take it up, you know, but that all these major monuments are with the government of India. So without the support of the government of India, we cannot do it. So they have to, first of all, we have to prepare them, the government of India. Now you should have a policy, a different policy, because you know things are not in very happy position. So you have to have a policy. For that also, there is a government fund also, that is the National Cultural Fund. But the thing is, you know, they should be given power and they should be told that now you have to act. That is what is lacking. And then the third thing is that market all these things. If you are ready to market, you know, the things will be automatically, people would be ready to invest money in all these things. As I told you earlier, it is not only a physical conservation, it is a kind of spiritual conservation also. Because when I was acting with these people, with the dacoits, you know, it was a completely spiritual transformation for the entire people. Similarly, in Chhattisgarh also, I acted with this an Excel group of people. So they captured me and my people also. We were at 9:30 at one particular, Dandewada mein hum log pahunche the, and they caught us. But then we engaged them in a discussion. So they took one 10,000 rupees, but for that they said that whenever, I mean, these people come, that is Naxalites from Andhra come, they would inform us we have to stop our work for 1 week or some 10 days, then they will inform us again once they go out from that area. So usi tarike se, I mean, we are able to conserve a number of temples in that area also. But now the government should think of it. Otherwise, you know, it's not possible. Then we can take up the monuments which are not under government. But most of the monuments are, big monuments are under government of India also, only. So they should come forward. That is why he said, we have a, Pragya Prabha has got a very important role to play. Now we should act. And we should tell them that you have to perform.
So sir, is there some government division that you are still overseeing or working with you actively, or how is that?
He
is
retired.
I am retired. I am retired from the Archaeological Survey of India. But now, this one, I mean, Sudha Murthy madam, is trying for the Bateshwar. And there are many temples, you know, in various parts of the country, in very bad condition. All of those things can be nursed back into good condition. And people are ready. The only thing...
But I think maybe, Mohammed ji, maybe one... recommendation that CSR funds can also be used for restoration of monuments probably will go a long way.
Yeah.
Probably Amendment in Companies Act will make a huge difference.
Yeah, that is what madam is doing, CSR funds.
Man, she has a lot of funds, so she's able to do it. But normal CSR funds never come for these kinds of, you know, it's not there in the Act. So probably she's pumping money from somewhere else, you know.
Yes.
Yeah, sure. Thank you,
Manu. One of the ideas I... just one thing. Like, Europe has barely a history of 400 years, 300 years, 100 years. Here, things, I mean, 400 years to logon ki purane haveliyan hoti hai jinme wo rehte hain.
Yes.
So, there is a lot, I mean, in Gwalior and Morena, I was told that there were a lot of temples, around 1200. I tried to invite that guy to the meeting, but I think he's busy. But sir, I'll stay in touch, sir, possibly.
Sure, thank you. See, as I was telling you, basically we Indians don't have any respect for our heritage.
Yes.
Once we have respect for heritage, governments will bend.
Yes.
We don't have respect for heritage. See. We go to our own monuments and then we scribble with something, chisel our love letters there on that, and we desecrate it. We don't have respect for it. So governments obviously are completely not bothered about it. Yeah. Abhinandan Reddy ji.
Sir. Yeah, can you hear me, sir?
Yeah.
Sir, my question is very simple, sir. It's as per Bateshwar temples, as per the internet, it says that there's a Shiva temple, Vishnu temple, and a Shakti temple. But is it primarily Shiva, or there are a bunch of...
Mainly Shiva, but yes, there are Vishnu temples also. The Shiva, the division of Shiva and Vishnu is mostly in southern India when we come to Tamil Nadu and other places. Otherwise, North India, there is not much of a division. So, Shivaya Vishnu Namaya, Shiva Namaya Vishnuve, Shivasya Hridayam Vishnu, Vishnusya Hridayam Shiva. But when we come to Tamil Nadu and Karnataka, there is some reservation is there.
Sir, another question, sir. It says that usually Vishnu temples are places where a lot of wealth is stored. Whereas it's a general perception that Shiva temples, there will be no wealth at all. So most of the Vishnu temples were desecrated and they were, looted and desecrated. Is that right? That is the history. That's what the history says.
Actually, this is an interpretation of the communist historians. Because, wherever there was a desecration of the temple, that was primarily because of the religious fanaticism. And of course, the second part is also there. That is, even now, whenever there is a riot in any place, and there will be one basic reason would be there, and then the looting also will take place. But because of the looting, we just cannot say it was because of the mainly because of this economic condition people had looted it. It is not like that. It was
because, sir, general perception is Vishnu temples, wealth was stored, but whereas Shiva temples, wealth was never stored. That is the that's what in the villages they say.
Absolutely wrong. Found it like that. So far, we have not found it like that one.
Yeah, okay. Absolutely wrong. Sir, absolutely wrong. In fact, the temple which was looted the most was Shiva temple in Somnath.
Yes, Somnath is
Shiva temple. Times it was looted, and they didn't loot it for the wealth.
Yes,
so I think Mamaji very correctly said, there is no evidence that these two are, correlated at all. It's all.
Sir, once
I think he was very blunt when he said it's a Marxist historian. I think he's very clear about it.
Sir, one small question, sir. Are any of your restored temples, are they live temples? Do people pray?
No, there is only one. There is one, only one Budeshwar Mahadev temple is there. But what we do is, at the time of over a monument, if it was under worship, only that would be permitted for worship. And if it was not under worship at the time of taking over, whether it is a mosque, whether it is a temple, then we would not be allowing any kind of new puja or worship or anything of that kind. So that is the ASI rule.
Yes.
For example, in Kanjipuram, it was already under worship. In Bradishara, it was already under worship. So it is going on. But in Mahabalipuram, it is not like that. It was not under worship, so we don't allow worship also.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you. And I think Prashiji is lifting his hand. But actually, there is an icon where you can click the button, sir. Your hand can show up. I think you don't know the feature. Yeah, that's okay.
Hello. Can you hear me?
We can hear you. So I was just telling you. Rashiji, there is a feature in Zoom where you can click a button and it will show a hand. There is a hand icon which will show against your name.
Sure.
Physically trying to show your hand. So that misses us.
I thought I had to do like this. Okay.
My full name
is I'm Prashant Maratta. I'm residing in Russia from last 25 years. And actually, I'm from Kashmir, Jammu Kashmir. Very nice to listen to. It was very knowledgeable. And I have been following you in a little bit. Whenever I have read about you. Mohammadji, my question was, as you are regional director of North India, so and Kashmir has been a very rich round of temples and history.
Your Marathans.
So just, exactly. And Sharda is in POK.
Yeah,
absolutely. I just wanted to ask, did you have the privilege of being to Kashmir and seen through the temples of Kashmir, if anything you can put light on that?
No, I had been to Kashmir and seen almost all these temples also. But you know, not as a man who, I was never posted there. So I could not take up any kind of conservation work there. Although I loved to take it up, I would have loved to take it up. But my posting was never there.
Okay.
But there so are and that has got its own Greek influence is there on temples of Mata temple, Surya temple, other temples also.
Yes.
Of Greek influence is very prominent, as if you are standing in Parthenon, or you would feel like that you are in one of the Greek temples of that country.
So, I wish you good luck, sir.
Rashidji, you can be in touch with us and I have gone and seen almost every temple in the valley.
Okay.
Right sure, from sure. Verinag in the south to Gurez. Every nook and corner I have traveled. So
great.
You tell me what temple you want, I'll give you the details.
Sure. Thank you very much.
Take it off.
And good luck.
We can take it offline. Thank you.
Thank you.
And I think last question, we'll take it. I think Balaji Krishnan ji, you had already asked a question, but you want to ask something else? Yeah, I think we'll take this as the last question and close it.
Yeah, I have another question. Mohammed sir, have you investigated Qutub Minar and Taj Mahal complexes? And if you have, then as per your investigation, was it actually a Jain or Hindu temple complex earlier?
No. Yes, I mean, this Qutub Minar area, that was there were 27 temples were there. And there is an inscription also. There it is written in the inscription also that 27 temples parts were used for this construction of Quwwat al-Islam Masjid. But not Qutub Minar. Qutub Minar is different that with this one. The whole concept itself is Islamic. But Quwwat al-Islam Masjid, that is just by the side of it. That is made out of the spoils of 27 temples. Even now, if you just go there, you will be finding a number of mutilated sculptures there. But as far as the Taj Mahal is concerned, you know, that is a completely different story. It is not neither Shiva temple nor Vishnu temple. These are, extreme that Hindu groups are, propagating this kind of thing. I was in charge of Taj Mahal also. And I have gone into all those kinds of basements also. There are no shivalingas. And they say that it is of 11th century Shiva temple was there, Taj Mahal. At that time, there was neither Arthas at that time, nor domes at that, nor minarets at that time, nor Pietra Dura works also in 11th century. Even during the period of Sultanate period also, the arches were not this kind of arches, the domes were not this kind of arches. It was double dome. The double dome came in Indian architecture only after the coming of the Mughals, not even during the Sultanate period also. You want that Taj Mahal should have been there even during the period of Babur or Humayun, it is not possible. It is a culmination of the architecture inherited. The Mughals had inherited from Samarkand, Bukhara and other places. So that is why if you want to place it even during the period of Jahangir also, it is not possible. So it is an architectural evolution. And we were not in Shiva monument, we were never using this kind of marble. Marble, either these people, Jain people were of course using, but otherwise, in Hinduism, we were never using this kind of marble. So it is an architectural evolution. That is another extreme Hindu group of people saying, they have not seen many of the temples. So if you go to Hoysaleshwara temples, see, beautiful temples are there in our own country, or even this Rajasthan. Jaina temples and others, excellent temples, Sometimes, for me, it looks more beautiful than that of Taj Mahal. So it's
Belur Halibut temples are wonderful.
Wonderful.
Says the case with Ramappa temple of Warangal.
Ramappa temple, yes.
Yeah.
So we should take people to all these places.
Yeah. Thank you so much, Mohammed ji. I'll just hand it over to my colleague Chandrasekhar ji to propose a formal vote of thanks.
Yes, sir.
It was our honor to have you and speak your heart out. For an organization like Pragya Pravah, you are actually giving a reality check in terms of what the current government is not doing. I think we have big takeaways and we have all big responsibilities. We are as frustrated as you are. We will definitely do our bit in whatever, we need to take it up with the government, or governments come and go, but then our fights are to go on.
Yes.
For the glory of Bharat.
Yes.
And, it's a great pleasure to have you, sir. And I'll just hand it over to my colleague Chandrasekhar ji to propose a formal vote of thanks.
Thank you. Thank you, Girdhar ji. Pranams, Mama ji.
Pranams, sir.
In fact, I have no enough words actually to commend your work, sir. But at the same time, I can't stop asking a quick question, sir. Please, if you allow me. My question is regarding this Chausat Yogini temple, sir, at Mitwala village in Morena.
Mitwali. Yeah.
I understand that you left it halfway because you are about to retire at the time. And my question is it the same way how you left it, or is there any progress after that, which actually is a replica of our Parliament House?
Yes. No improvement. No improvement. This
and
as I left it.
Yeah.
There is one Chauset Devi temple in Jabalpur also.
Oh yes, Beragat. Beragat.
Yeah, that I saw.
Yeah.
Exactly.
This one.
But not a single idol in that has been spared. Everything has been desecrated.
Yes. That is, because of the Alauddin Khilji and later on also, it was completely desecrated.
But I think this one is this one stands as a replica of our Parliament House, right?
Yes, that is also a replica of the Parliament. That was Beragat House.
Beragat House.
Great, sir. Thank you, sir. This has been a wonderful session, quite enlightening. And like I already said, I have no enough words to commend your work, sir. We are really proud of your knowledge, your nationalistic ideology, and your role in protecting our culture and heritage, especially your courage as well. And our salute and respect, sir, for your keen interest in restoring Hindu temples, which is actually in a dacoit concentrated area. And also we actually salute your the person inside you who is a poet, a critic, and also a human, sir. We can see that you have done this not because that was your job, but actually you have a lot of respect, passion, and interest for this. That's the reason why you did it. We can see that very clearly. And the pictures and the animation you have shown, they are actually touchy and painful as well, sir. What you have done is not an easy job. It was just phenomenal. And it's only possible when someone has a lot of determination. And I'm sure you must have had a lot of stress as well. And the temples you have actually brought from ruins to those restored, the pictures of those, they really make us happy, sir. I'm telling you from the bottom of my heart. And also, when you transform these ruins to the temple, to the temples, of the temples to the restored temples, you not only transform those, but also those dacoits, I'm sure, sir, they must have had a lot of change in their thought process as well. I wish these destructive-minded people who are living amongst us in our country, they watch these and they understand the difference between those constructive and destructive concepts. I wish they could see those and they could see your work, sir. And finally, I'm sure definitely, like already Girdhaji mentioned and you said as well, you must definitely have had some spiritual connection with Lord Shiva. And I'm sure you are a blessed person. By interacting with you, we also feel we are also blessed, sir. Thanks so much. And like I already said, and we don't have enough words. Thanks for your good work, sir. Pranams.
Thank you, and thanks all the audience who have been supporting us and been part of this great moment in this very difficult times. Thank you all. Bharat Mata Ki Jai.
Namaste. Thank you, sir. Bharat Mata Ki Jai.